Hello everyone, and peace of Christ to all of you. Please invite your friends and have a good time together, enjoying the teaching of the Lord and in the same time exposing the liars. Before we start, as you see in the screen, this is my book translated to the Bahasa language, and it's for free. So if you are an Indonesian and who don't speak English or good English, and you prefer to have a book in your computer for free as a gift from me, Christian Prince, the link is in the info. Please feel free to download your copy. And again, this is for free. It's not for sale. It's a gift from me for every Indonesian in the world. And soon we are going to publish more books in more languages for free too. The Deception of Allah is a very important book. And now we have two of my books in the Indonesian language. Actually, if you have this one alone, is enough for you not only to debate Muslims, but to smash Allah and His Prophet between you two fingers. Just you need two fingers only. So I advise all Indonesian people to read it. And as you see, it's for free. It takes you only one click to have it. You will lose nothing. And I invite Muslims to read it. What you will lose? Let us see how good your God is. And for the same time, you will see knowledge and information you never heard of before. So feel free to download your copy. So while we are asking Indonesian to get my copy for free, we have the Muslim mullahs asking people to call and buy the book. You see how decent they are? I mean, this guy, he is getting tons of donation. He created a center. Whatever, you know, obviously it's a business, and he got a lot of support, and he live in an Islamic country, you know, where the major support is a must. I mean, this is like, it's not like a joke. It's not like we are individual in YouTube here and there trying to fight the cult of Islam. This is what they do, and this is what we do. Do this guy really need money? Do he really need support? Why he keeps saying, asking you to buy his books? This is the case for all Muslims. You will see Mimi Hijab when he starts his video. He holds a little ball. He says, buy brother, buy this brother, brother, buy it. You know, what is that, Vaseline? All of them, they are promoting, they are doing business. Indonesian people are poor, and it's not a secret. So if you care for the poor, you see, I understand, okay, you need to support yourself. But do you have something for the poor? Your country is poor. So why you are doing such a business? It's about God. Anyway, you notice that this guy, he don't dare to put my name in his title no more. And actually all of them, they try me once and then never again. When we see Muslims speaking about God and religion, you will notice right away that those Muslims do not know anything about what they are talking about themselves. Let us hear what this guy wants to say to us, and we go from there.
Title is Jesus guaranteed enter the heaven? Christian Prince and perhaps most Christians believe that only by having a faith and trusting Jesus will be guaranteed to enter the heaven. As a matter of fact, such belief is wrong and even misleading. If just believe in Jesus...
Stop. No, let me correct you, my friend. Brother, if you want to go to heaven, brother, you have to kill some Christians, brother, and some Jews, brother, and some atheists, brother. And don't forget, brother, to have sex with a 6 years old, brother. And don't forget, brother, that you are allowed to lie in 3 cases, brother. to your wife, to your friends, and to your friends, brother. And that will make you a perfect holy person, brother. And then don't forget, brother, to drink camel urine in the morning, because the Prophet, he ordered us to do so, brother. And then take a shower with dead dogs and bread with women for period. And that will make you clean, brother, before you do prayer, brother. And don't forget, brother, that if a donkey and a woman and a camel, brother, walk by, your prayer is accepted, brother. So avoid them, brother, so your brother can be. You are going to tell us how to go to heaven? All right. Tell us more, Abdul.
Men will be safe. Then all Muslims will be safe, because all of them believe and have a faith in Jesus.
I mean, I never saw a stupid idiot can beat this guy. Actually, I saw, to be honest with you. I'm just joking. Don't feel so bad about yourself. There's more bad than you. Come on. I'm just joking, exaggerating like Muhammad when he said that Allah will give you a wife, her butt is 1 mile. Don't you think he was exaggerating? I mean, why you don't make it two mile? 1 mile only? This is so small. I mean, the bigger, the better. Size doesn't matter. And your private part will be endless. I mean, endless. So you live in Jakarta and your penis is in New York? What New York? It's endless. What are you talking about? So listen, Abdul. Look at this logic. If everyone believes in Jesus, he will go to heaven based on this. If you believe that, if you believe in Jesus, you go to heaven. Abdul, you don't believe in Jesus. The Bible says, who is the Antichrist? And it says, the Antichrist is the one who denied the Father and the Son. And you deny both. So you are not a person who have faith in Jesus. You are an Antichrist. Shall I show you the verse? Hold on. Give me a second. So in 2 seconds, you will see how everybody will start laughing at you, because officially you are an idiot. And not only that, by the way, it says, who is the liar? Who is what? Who is the liar? So you are a liar. Your prophet is a liar, officially. 1 John, this is one verse. We can show you the other verses too. Who is the liar? Abdul, who is the liar? The liar is Muhammad. The liar is you. The liar, anyone who says that Jesus is not the Christ, and he is an Antichrist. And we do what? And he denies the Father and the Son. Do you believe that Jesus is the Son of God? You don't. So you are the liar, potato. I mean, even the word potato, you don't deserve it, to be honest with you. I mean, potato are delicious. You know, but I say potato because I fry them always. And we fry you each time we speak about you. I mean, you are a joker, man. You know what is my worry? Is your wife. I feel sorry for her. Imagine you have a husband all day long next to you and he speaks this garbage. Oh, boy. All right. So, brother, if believing in Jesus, brother, that means all Muslims are saved, brother. No, you don't. If you believe in Jesus, why you kill Christians? If you Muslims, Muhammad, and believe in Jesus, so why you follow a book says kill the Christians? Huh? Eh? So you believe in Jesus, but you want to kill those who believe in Jesus? I mean, how nice of you. Did the person in the name of the Christian Prince anything that you Muslims, if you believe in Jesus, why you kill Christian? First of all, we don't kill Christian. No, we don't kill them. We slaughter them only. We chop their head. This is not true. This is the false information and this is fake news. Is this your book says kill the Christians and the Jews? And if they want to live, they have to pay you, because which means you are a mafia. So you are a person who believe in Jesus, but you want to kill the Christians. You are a person who believe in Jesus, but you want to chop their head. You want to take their money, you want to humiliate them, you want to make them, force them to walk in the sewage, and you want to rape their women. And you are a person who is following Jesus. Isn't it Jesus says, don't fight evil by evil? Isn't it Jesus says, the one who slammed your right cheek, give him the other one? So how you say you believe in Jesus? Since when? Black stone kisser. You are so delicious, black stone. I love you, love you, love you. Chiku, 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 chiku. By the way, I had a conversation with the black stone in the other day. And I said to myself, a black stone, why? Should I say why the same way he said? Why, Christian Prince? What? Why? I mean, your why scared the hell of me, man. What is that? Okay. Blackstone Kisser talking about being saved by Jesus. Is that a joke? So, you know, I was like having conversation with myself because sometimes I do that like Muhammad. Muhammad, he hear voices. I heard voices. I mean, I have the right to hear voices like everybody. You know, it's not fair that Muhammad can hear voices. I cannot hear voices. So I said to myself, if I want to believe in Allah, and Allah, he sent me a stone, why the stone is in the shape of a vagina? Can you answer the question, potato, tomato, what's your name? Why this stone is in the shape of a vagina? And how this stone can be the right hand of God? And how you say you have believed in Jesus, but you kiss stones? Hello? Anyway, let it go. And by the way, Muhammad, sorry, that I say Muhammad, I can't say that. The Muslim will be offended. Hello? Are you crazy or what? They will be offended. They are the fastest offended people in the world. They, you know, the Muslims, they get offended from anything. But they offend everyone. They call you kuffar. They call you pig. We call you son of monkeys. They call you all kind of names. But the second you say to them, Abdul, which is part of the religion, by the way, I'm not calling them names. They say, you are calling us Abdul. Do you remember Sheikh Abdul Wadud when he called me and he said, I will give you an example, Christian Prince. As an example, there's a guy, his name is Abdul. I was saying to myself, what the heck? He's stealing my copyright phrase. Anyway, so I asked myself, as long as Allah is God, why does God, excuse me, he needs such a stone? And this stone, brother, according to the prophet, is going to have a mouth in the judgment day, brother. And it's going to have two eyes, brother. I'm sexy, mean. I'm sexy and you know it. Okay, wonderful. Look at this, man. And the brother... this stone, brother, is going to witness for us, brother, in the judgment day, which means she is going to have a tongue. Oh, boy. What a tongue, man. And you are telling me you are a follower of Jesus, a person who believes in all this garbage? The black stone is going to have eyes and tongue and is going to witness for everyone who did give her a kiss and hug. Allah, this guy, he kissed me. Yes, here he kissed me. I witness for that, Allah. Unbelievable, unbelievable. So beautiful. So beautiful and so sexy. Let us continue with this idiot. I mean, where does idiot come from? I mean, it is a manufacturer for them somewhere. I'm not sure where they're coming from. I'm going to try to trace the source of this thing, you know. Okay, let us continue with this guy. Genius.
For you to know, Prince, Jesus said that the requirement to enter heaven was doing everything according to the will of his Father or Allah.
Stop. And supposedly you Muslims are the one who do the will of the Father. You don't believe in the Father, you idiot, first of all, to do his will. Because the second you say, to do the will of the Father, that means you just accepted that Jesus is the Son of God. For why he is calling Father? For this is his Father. Secondly, we just showed you how many things you break. And actually, I will show you from your own words how many things you break against God. Continue.
In the Gospel of Matthew, chapter number 7, First number 21.
I like it when he act like he's trying to. In the book of Matthew, verse number 21. We can see you. You are looking at the computer in front of you. Like, hello? Okay. What it says there? Tell us.
Jesus said, not everyone who calls me Lord, Lord, Lord will enter.
Please say it again. Say it again and take 44 pesos. What? What he will say? Say again.
Not everyone who calls me Lord, Lord, Lord.
I don't know, it sounds like a chicken for me, to be honest with you. But anyway, I get it. Not everyone says to me, Lord, Lord. I don't know why you make those noises, man. I mean, this is funny. Is there something wrong with your teeth or your throat? I'm not sure. Go ahead.
Will enter the kingdom of heaven.
Okay.
But only those who do what my Father in heaven wants them to do.
Okay.
A question to you, Christian Prince. Have you ever done anything according to the will of Jesus' Father? Or
okay, hold on. Why you skip the sentence you just read for us from the Bible, you idiot? You just said that Jesus said, okay, hold on, let me take a snapshot for it. Smile, please. I'm going to take a selfie for you. Hold on.
Only those who do what my Father in heaven wants them to do.
Hold on.
To me, Lord, 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 will enter the kingdom of heaven.
Okay, stop. I just took selfie for you. I apologize for the camera sound, the noise. But my camera is noisy. Lord, Lord. Okay. So this is what you say to us. And here in a second, everybody will be laughing at you and your stupidity. Isn't it you in the previous video, you said to me, where Jesus says I'm God and you challenge me to find one verse in the Bible, you idiot. Is that you? And now you are quoting the verse I showed you to show you that you are an idiot, to show me that I'm wrong. Let me make it simple for you. Isn't it you who challenged me to show you a verse in the Bible where it says that Jesus is God? And then I did show you this verse from the Bible to show you that you are an idiot and this is Jesus says I'm God. And now you are showing me this verse to prove to me that I do not know. I mean, are you an idiot? Yes, you are. Not everyone who call me God, God will enter the kingdom of heaven. You just admitted that Jesus is God, you idiot. In the end of the same video, he will say to you, this is a proof that Jesus is not God. Do you see how stupid he is? I think you are a very healthy man. You know, I mean, especially your brain. I'm fascinated with your brain. I mean, look at this brain. A lot of curves there. Curvy. So not everyone who call me Lord, Lord will enter the kingdom of heaven. Not everyone, which means there is many they will call me Lord, God. They will go to heaven, but not everyone. Who is the one who will go to heaven? The one who do the will of my Father. And what is the will of my Father is my will. For me and the Father is one. You are an idiot. And everybody will be laughing at you. And now how many Muslims will leave Islam because of such an idiot? I mean, God, he blessed us, by the way, by those idiots. Like Yasser Kadri, Mimi, Fifi, whatever, those idiots. They don't talk, they do poo-poo. So Allah, he don't pray for, he pray to, brother. Unbelievable. So, you are quoting for me this verse, and there's no more details need to be given. Jesus is God in the Bible, and you are saying to me that you agree with it. Tell us more, Abdul. Tell us love more.
But only those who do what my Father in heaven wants them to do. A question to you, Christian Prince. Have you ever done anything according to the will of Jesus Father or Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala? I really believe.
Can I talk? I just clicked the wrong direction. Sorry, guys. I clicked the wrong direction. He was asking me questions. Okay. Say again.
Enter the heaven. Christian prince, and perhaps most Christians believe that only by having a faith and trusting Jesus will be guaranteed to enter the heaven. As a matter of fact, such belief is wrong and even misleading. If just believe in Jesus, man will be safe. Then
I think I apologize, guys. I just skipped this. We are going back too much. Okay.
Jesus said that the requirement to enter heaven was doing everything according to the will of his Father or Allah.
Allah is the Father?
In the gospel.
Stop! Now, Islam believe that Allah is the Father? Is that a new religion, brother? I mean, what is wrong with this guy? Where we got those guys from? Now, you Muslim believed Allah is the Father suddenly? How come? How come?
Gospel of Matthew, chapter number 7. First number 21, Jesus said, "Not everyone who calls me Lord, Lord, Lord will enter the kingdom of heaven, but only those who do what my Father in heaven wants them to do." A question to you, Christian Prince. Have you ever done anything according to the will of Jesus Father or Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala?
Yes, please, can I answer, please? My hand is up. Yeah, please, me. No, I'm here. No, don't look at that. Don't look at the computer. I'm here. Okay. Yes, I did. I'm spanking you. I mean, don't you see? Yes, I'm doing a lot of things according to the teaching of God. But I can't say that I am a perfect man. You know, all of us, we commit sin, my friend. As an example, I just said... you're a genius, which is a truth, which is a lie. But I was joking, and God understand, you know. Unbelievable, you're so cute. Okay, so Christian friends, did you see anything? Did you do anything according to that? Yeah, I did. There's thousands of people leaving Islam every day because of my videos, my friend. Not hundreds. We don't know how many. We don't know how many. Do you know how many Indonesian every day watch my videos? You will not believe it. Go and search. Go.
I really believe that you haven't.
Really? How come?
For example, according to Leviticus.
Hold on, this needs some coffee. Now he was given to give me example. And those examples are very heavy. Here we go. I got my coffee now. Okay, go ahead. For example.
Chapter number 11. First number 7. Pig is unclean. But you eat it, don't you?
Don't you? First of all, who told you that I eat pig? Who told you? You have a security camera spying on me, brother? How you know? Maybe I don't eat it. Abdul, as long pigs are unclean, so why you Muslims eat it? Let me show everybody that you're an idiot, you do not know your book. If we go in the Quran, we will find that Muslims, they can eat the pig. And it doesn't say it's not clean, you are stupid. And if we ask the Muslims why the Quran says don't eat pigs, there's no answer. Because Muhammad's trying to copy the Jews. Okay. Remember, when you talk about Islam, you are talking to Christian friends. And we will spank you wherever you go. Chapter 5, verse number 3. It says, forbidden for you the dead meat, the blood, the flesh of a swine. You know, if you go to Azhar University, you will see they have in their book, in the text, actually they have it in memory TV, you can watch the video, where scholars teaching that you can eat a Muslim who left Islam after cooking him. If he is a Christian, you can eat him raw, not cooked. And you are talking about pigs unclean. Aren't you Muslims who drink the camel urine? Is that clean? Huh? Isn't you Muslims who drink the blood of your prophet? Is that clean? Literally blood, not like the Christian Jesus, he says to them, do this to remember me. This is my blood and the bread. This is my body. But this is not physically. You Muslims, you drank physically the urine of the prophet, which is a false prophet, and the blood of your prophet, which is a false prophet, and his blood was poisoned even. Then it says, forbidden for you to eat it the following, the flesh of a swine. But why? Where it says unclean? Nowhere. Is dead meat unclean? Blood and flesh of a swine. Okay, and then he says, however, brother, if you are hungry, brother, you can eat it. Do you see it? Brother? But if any of you force by hunger, you can eat it. So if you are hungry, you eat it. Secondly, brother, how stupid your Quran, brother. Isn't it Allah who said that you can eat the food of the Christians? Huh? How you agree that Christians, they eat pig, as you said, yet the Quran, he gave you an order to eat our food. So look what we found. We found in the Quran, there's a teaching of contradiction. That those Muslims, they are fake. Muhammad is fake. He's not a Muslim. He don't have a religion. Because religion should be stable, not to contradict itself. So when you say that you cannot eat pigs, and you are saying that the Christians, they eat pig, that means you are a pig, for you do not do what Allah told you not to do. Because remember, according to Islam, the one who disobey Allah, Allah will make him a pig. Hello? So you are disobeying Allah's order, because Allah, he order you, not me, for I don't believe in him. Let us go here. Do you see it? All those verses speaking about making you a pig and a monkey if you disobey Allah. And now you are disobeying Allah. That means Allah, he made you a pig and a monkey. If we go in the Quran, we will find that the Quran order you to eat the food of the Christians and the Jews. Chapter 5, verse number 5. And what make it more funny, by the way, that both verses are in the same chapter. This chapter is saying to you, don't eat the food which contain pig. And then one verse after, this is verse number 4, and this is verse number 5, it says, today you can eat the food of the people of the book. It is lawful for you. So how you can eat our food, and yet you should not do eat our food, and you just said to me that I will not go to heaven because I'm eating my food. Guys, do you see what I'm talking about? People, do you understand how stupid what he just said? He just said, if you eat the Christian prince, he will not go to heaven. Why? Because he eat pig. Correct? Okay. And the Quran forbid him from eating pig. Okay. But it says in the same page that you can eat the people of the book, food, whatever it is. It's all their food. He did not say exception. He said all the food of the Christians and the Jews is lawful for you. So you have a stupid religion, a stupid book. Don't your prophet knew what the Christians teach and what the Christian believe? You are an idiot, and everybody will be laughing at you. And in the same time, as you see, the Quran says you can eat pigs if you are hungry. The book of Musa, as I know, did not say that, brother. Now let us go back to this Abdul. Okay, where do we stop you? Where do we stop you? We stop you here. Okay, let us go a little bit so we can hear more of your wisdom. Okay, give us more, brother.
But you eat it, don't you? According to the gospel of...
Hold on. Just to show you how stupid you are. The verse you are quoting me from the Old Testament. Let us go back. This is the verse, right? Okay, chapter 11, verse number 7. Did you even read what it says, you idiot? I'm sure you did not, because you're an idiot of the village, or maybe the town, or maybe all of Indonesia. It's in the top, it says, that God, he spoke to Moses, and he said to him, go speak to the children of Israel. So this was a command for the children of Israel. This is number one. It's command for who? Specifically, children of Israel. Let us go to the Quran, just to show you. I mean, I don't know, I feel sorry for this guy. I don't think he have a place to spank him anymore. If we search the word Bani Israel, which means children of Israel, we will find it all over the Quran. Look how many times. Your prophet, man, he's so good in that. But if we ask Moses, who are the children of Israel, ask Muhammad, who is Israel? Muhammad will not tell us because he do not know. Where in the Quran it says who is this guy Israel? Huh? And if we read carefully what supposedly Allah allowed the children of Israel to do, you will find that you Muslims, you broke all the command of the God of Israel. Huh? We can show you tons of reference as an example. First of all, the book of the Muhammadan, the yellow pages of Muhammad, it says that the Jews are favored people upon all mankind. And this is total contradiction for what Muhammad, he says, and the Quran says. Muhammad, he says, and the Quran says, you were a best nation came to mankind. Chapter 3, verse 110. So how the Jews are the best nation for mankind, and then to chapter 3, verse 110, it says, you are the best people ever for mankind. The answer is very simple. Muhammad is stupid. He do not know what he's saying. In the beginning, he was trying to be hypocrite to the Jews, saying to them, hey, Jews, Allah favor you, Jews. Just believe in me, Jews. When the Jews give him their bum and they fart at him, Muhammad, he changed the tone. He says, Jews, you are pigs, you are monkeys. We are the best people of mankind. Unbelievable. I love you, love you, love you. Guys, don't you miss me? How many of you miss me? I just see. Nobody, huh? Man, not even one. No problem, no problem. Okay. Jibril, he miss me. I would go, yes, Jibril is squeezing me right now 3 times, and he says to me, read. And I say to him, I cannot read. And he said to me, read, you idiot. I say, I cannot read. I mean, who is the idiot here? The one who say, I do not know how to read, or the one who keeps insisting saying, read, you idiot. He just told you he cannot read. What's wrong with you? What's wrong with you? Leave Brittany alone. He told you he cannot read. Unbelievable. What's wrong with you? Too good to go, to go. Okay, so you are the best of people, but this verse says that the Jews are. Do you see it? Children of Israel, specifically. So as you notice here, Abdul, your God, as an example, he ordered the children of Israel to go and kill the Palestinian. Your God, are you going to go and kill the Palestinian? Hey, Muhammad in Indonesia, are you going to follow Allah teaching to kill the Palestinian? This is your Quran, my friend. It says that Allah, he ordered the Jews to go and kill the Palestinian. O my people, enter the Holy Land which Allah has assigned unto you. Okay, do what? Kill the Palestinians. You Muslims today, you are against those who they are doing the order of Allah according to you. And you are talking about following God. I don't know. Amoga, CP, Kasep, Pesia, Barbara, Barabahas. You know, by the way, my Indonesian language is very good. Let me translate for you. Okay, hold on. Let us take a break from this idiot. Okay. Our friend here, he says, his name Indonesian CP. Semong, Samoga, CB, Kevat, Bisa, Barbahasa, Indonesia. Okay, translation. Brother editor, there's a person, he said in the battle with that TB is a Kabit, Bethiaya, Basazata, Bahadasa. I don't know. Okay, you know? And now this is a very, very miracle word because nobody understands what Allah just said. We ask the Muslims, what are those letters and the words in the Quran? They say those miracles, nobody understands them. In Islam and only in Islam, if you cannot understand what the Quran is saying, that is a miracle. Unbelievable. We just had a miracle right now because I don't know what this guy is saying. So it's a miracle. He must be Allah too. Unbelievable. Hey, coffee for you, my friend. Here we go. I hate you all. You know it. I hate you and you know it. All right. Let us go back to this idiot.
Pig is unclean, but you eat it, don't you?
Yeah, Ibni, yeah. Listen, Abdul, you eat pigs too, and we just saw you the verse, and you drink piss too. Did the Bible say drink piss? Do you see how serious a crime this is for God to drink piss? According to, you know, you're an idiot.
According to the Gospel of Luke, chapter number 2, verse number 21, Jesus was circumcised. Christian prince, read carefully this verse. A week later, when the time came for the baby to be circumcised, he was named Jesus, the name which the angel had given him before he had been conceived.
Did you hear this? Jesus have a name before even his mother she have him. Hold on. So the angels, they named him Jesus, or God, he named him Jesus. Secondly, Abdul, if we go to your Quran, I don't know, I mean, I'm trying to let it go, but this guy, he keep doing poo-poo, and I like to spank, I cannot resist the temptation. Let us see what the Quran says about that. Oh boy. Chapter 3, verse number 45, it says that the angels came to Mary and said to her, we are here to give you glad tidings, glad news, the gospel actually. It's called, this is what the word means. Al-Bishara. So look what the Quran just admitted. that Jesus himself is the word of God by saying to her, we are here to give you the gospel, which is the gospel, which is the word of God, which is Jesus. We are here to give you Bishara, Yubashiruki, a word from him. Who is that Jesus? So this is the first name was given to Jesus, actually. It's the word of God. And this is in total agreement with the book of John. For this is not only a name, he is the word. In the beginning it was the word, and the word was with God, and the word is the God. He is the word of God, and he is God. His name, and here the false translation says, will be Christ. That's false. Doesn't say his name will be. It says his name is a Christ. إِذْ قَالَتِ الْمَلَائِكَةُ يَا مَرْيَمُ إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُبَشِّرُكِ بِكَلِمَةٍ مِّنْهُ إِسْمُهُ الْمَسِيحُ. إِسْمُهُ الْمَسِيحُ. His name is the Messiah, not his name will be the Messiah. Fraud, liars. Which means he was exist previous to his birth. For he is the Messiah. His name is the Messiah, not his name will be the Messiah. And he was exist in heaven before he came to earth. How? As the word of God. The Quran confirmed. And what is the word of God? Is God. In Islam, we have a problem here because Muslims believe that the Quran is word of God, but yet it is not created by God. Which means we have to divine. In Christianity, we don't have a problem. Because when we say Jesus is the word of God, for he is God and God is his word, that will be perfect sense. In Islam, when they say that the Quran is created, yet it is the word of God, so where is the word of God is coming from? They say to you, from God. So is it created? They say no. So is the word of God is God? They say no. So you have two any created divine in Islam, which is very stupid belief. So here we notice that the name of Christ is not just a name. And the second you say that Jesus is the name was given to him, and the second you confirm that Christ is a name was given to him in Islam, you just admitted that he is the Savior. Thank you very much. Not Muhammad. So the Savior is a Christ. The Savior is Jesus. If we ask this Abdul, what Jesus mean? You do not know. I mean, how even you use the word Jesus, you do not know it's mean. By the way, what Isa mean? You don't know. Not a single Muslim knew what Isa mean. Not a single Muslim.
It means that Jesus circumcised.
Okay.
But you weren't circumcised, weren't you?
Oops, let me check, please. Abdul, I mean, what? Okay, I'm going to ask you a very simple question, and everybody will be laughing at you for a century. And I want people to cut those videos pieces, because each one of them, each part is embarrassing. According to you, the one who is not circumcised, he will not go to heaven. I challenge you, Abdul, I challenge you to show me where Muhammad did circumcision. Where and when? Never. You just admitted that the one who do not do circumcision, as you understand, will not go to heaven. Did Muhammad do circumcision? I challenge let me say it the same as you. All the Muslims in the world to show us where and when Muhammad did circumcision. He did not. And secondly, as long as you admitted that the Bible says to do circumcision, and this is for the Old Testament, for the Jews, as we showed you, the verse says, tell the children of Israel. Who is the children of Israel? Those are the children of Israel, which means they are from his seed. Where in the Quran the word circumcision mentioned? How come here it's important to mention to the God of Moses, and you Muslim claim that the same God of Moses is the same God of Muhammad? How come in the book of Moses, God said to Moses, tell the children of Israel to do circumcision? How come Allah forgot to mention that in his book? You will not find it. Because the Quran never was a book and is a stupid collection of stories. Otherwise, here we go. God of the Jews says, don't do this. Can you show me where the God of Muslims say, don't do say this? So you say to me, Muhammad, he said. Well, Muhammad, he said that to you, but he did not do it. And if Muhammad said that to you, he get it from where? The order, he get it from where? If you say Allah, give it to him, show us the verse. Now, let us continue with this idiot. So he was saying to me, he's asking me if I am circumcised or not. I'm not going to tell you really. This is very sexual question. Same on you. Same on you to ask me about my private part. However, I want to ask you the same question. Are you circumcised? I will shave my 20-foot beard if you are. You are not. And you are asking me if I am circumcised. I mean, those people are really idiot. Now listen, those who understand the Bible very well, they knew what is written in the Bible. And I will show you from the Old Testament what is the meaning of circumcision. You see, God, he gave Moses orders, and those orders, they make sense for reason. As an example, when God, he says, don't eat pork, is that because pork really, I mean, pork is just an animal, and food can be, you know, to survive, you know. But God, he forbid them from eating pigs, because pigs, they eat everything. So because of their diet, they can bring risk. However, risk can come from all kinds of animals. There's a flu can come from chicken. There's a flu can come from cows. There's a virus is called the mad cow. There's, all kinds of diseases can be transmitted through animals. So that means we should not eat any of those animals, right? But because pigs, they eat the flesh of a human, because they were not, you know, maintained. Let me drink some water. Sometime when you are talking, you swallow that. It's my coffee. See, I should not drink coffee, but I love it. I cannot resist. Brother, did Allah forbid coffee? So, the pig is not the problem for God. That will be silly. That will be very silly, my friend. God does not affect by you eating it. Pigs, Jesus said, it's not what go inside your mouth will make you dirty, but what come from your mouth. Let us get the verses. And here you will see the stupidity of those who claim they go and they quote a verse from the Bible, but don't understand what the Bible is teaching. Give me a second, please. So as long you are asking me to obey God, read carefully. What goes into someone's mouth, actually this is a translation I don't like, it's a bad translation, an international version. By the way, the Muslim, they said to you how many versions you have of the Bible. Those are translation, you idiot. It's you who have many Quran. For us, we don't. Those are translations. So I know I can make a translation of the Bible. That will be a new version. Now, you see that Jesus said, it is not what goes inside your mouth, what make you dirty, what make you not pure, but what come from you from it. And that not only smart, it's super smart, genius, makes sense, unbelievable logic. You Muslims, you claim that you are pure because you don't eat pork, but you drink piss. Of what? Of an animal. Of what? A camel. And even you drunk the piss of your prophet. So you claim to be pure, but yet you eat dirty stuff, filthy stuff. It's a piss. Literally, it's a piss. Piss is the waste of anybody, any living creature. It's a waste. Even the camel rejected. Even the body of the camel dumped. So it is not what go inside your mouth, and this is Matthew chapter 15, verse number 11, will make you dirty, but what go inside your come from your mouth. And that's what Jesus is talking about. And the same for circumcision. And let me spank you again, for you are an idiot. And what we can do, we have to do it. I mean, what we can do. This is the Old Testament too. This is not the New Testament. Here is speaking about circumcision. If you read carefully, you will see that circumcision here presenting something very important for us. That what circumcision is in the book, in verse number 16, circumcise therefore the foreskin of your heart. What the heart present? The heart present dignity, honesty. Like you say to me, tell me from your heart the truth. Speak the truth of your heart. If you love somebody, you have it in your heart. If you hate somebody, you have it in your heart. This is a phrase, a statement of expression. Circumcision, the skin of your heart, the foreskin of your heart. But do we really do circumcision for our heart? No. So what the Bible concentrate in is the benefit of the man as health, but the most important is circumcision of your heart. Your heart is about being pure. You know, when being given orders to circumcision, it's not a secret that circumcision is very good. Now some scientists don't agree, says it's not good. But however, in the old days, when we're talking about thousands of years ago, people, they are not in easy access to water, taking shower every day. They can have illness in that area. So circumcision was for the benefit of the man, not for the benefit of God. Otherwise, God, he don't really care if you have that peace. He is the one who made it that peace for you. But you Muslims, you go extreme in stupidity, and you do circumcision for women. You cut her, you know, her clitoris, so she have no joy in her life no more. And if we ask you, where you get this from? You say the prophet said, but where the prophet get this from? There's no answer. So you have a wrong understanding about the order. Same time, we can show you that from the beginning of the church, that the Christians, they agree that circumcision was given to the Jews, and the Jews kept their order, as we showed you in the book of the one you quote, chapter number 12, that this was an order for children of Israel. So when the disciple of Jesus, they met together, they agree that, okay, well, this was an order for the Jews. However, those who they are not Jews, why they should do it? And the verses in front of you, you can read it, and everybody will see that you are literally an illiterate in the Bible, and you do not know what you are talking about, right? When a Jew come to them, as an example, in the book of Acts, chapter 15, because he's a Jew, he have to keep the commandment. He's a Jew. He's from the children of Israel, as we showed you. Speak to the children of Israel. So there is a covenant was given to the children of Israel, and the children of Israel have to keep the command. As an example, when Jesus was doing his miracles and his act and his action, the Jews, they accuse him and his disciples that they are doing work in Saturday. What Jesus said? Sabbath was made for the man, not the man was made for Sabbath. So you are a person who is a hypocrite, who is trying to make it like because of that we will not go to heaven. And by the way, so you are saying to me, if a person don't do this, he will not go to heaven, right? Okay. The Bible have an answer for that. The Bible confirm that if a person he in being circumcised, is he going to go to heaven? No. Unless he is obeying God. So circumcision alone is just a symbolic thing for you being a follower of God. If you go to the book of Romans, For circumcision, fairly purified, okay, if you keep the law. So those are the one who have the law already. All right? But if you are a breaker of the law, then your circumcision is useless. You are uncircumcised. So what is circumcision really in the Old Testament and the New Testament? It is keeping the law. It's not that peace. So you can be circumcised, and then you break the law of God, then you are uncircumcised, which means you are unpurified. Therefore, the one who is not circumcised, and he keep righteous of the law, he will not go to heaven? Isn't going to be really accounted as a circumcision? Do you see it? So the one who keep the law truly is the one who consider purified. So those idiots who they go and they copy and paste, who do not know really what the Bible teach, they can be refuted so easy. And we laugh at them. And look how beautiful this logic is. So are you saying to me that circumcision, because he might say to you, oh, there's a verse that says, unless you are circumcised. This is circumcision we're talking about. Circumcision of your heart, circumcision of your purity, of your dignity, of you being follower of God. This is why Jesus says, not everyone says to me, Lord, Lord. Okay, you can do circumcision, you are a Jew. And you come to Jesus, says, I believe in you, but you don't do what Jesus ordered you to do. You're a drug dealer. You're a thief like Muhammad. Child molester like Muhammad. Killer. You broke all the command of God by being Muhammad follower. From kissing stones, bowing in front of stones, going around the stones, killing innocent people, rioting, looting, even lying. When God, he says, don't lie. When God said, don't commit murder. When God said, don't steal. Even if you find the ox of your enemy, you give it back to him. If there is somebody, he is your enemy, and you find his animal lost, you give it to him. Right? Apostate, protestate, or state when I call. Who is this guy, apostate? So anyway, let us continue with this guy, just to show you how silly they are. Actually, it's not worth to make it long video, but I will continue a little bit.
According to the Gospel of Matthew, chapter number...
Yeah, it is. We answered this one. Let us skip a little bit so we can laugh. Okay, here.
First number four. Jesus instructed to worship Allah only.
Really?
But on the other hand, you worship Jesus.
Okay, hold on. So he said in Matthew, right? Let us go back a little bit, show you on the screen. Matthew chapter 10, verse number 4. Okay, I will go there. And you know, the most they ask me to read those verses, the more we laugh at them. I will go there right now. Matthew chapter 10. Let everybody laugh at you. And remember, when they say, there Jesus, he ordered you. They can't say he did not. Remember that. He just said, or Jesus, he ordered you. What Jesus, he ordered us. Let us hear together the word of God, the Messiah, the Lord, the Savior. And everybody will be dying laughing at your stupidity.
Matthew 10. And when he had called unto him his 12 disciples, he gave them power against unclean spirits to cast them out, and to heal all manner of sickness and all manner of disease. Now the names of the 12 apostles are these.
Hold on. Chapter 10, proving that Jesus is God. He is the one who quoted, not me. If I am a prophet of God, and remember, Muhammad himself, he have a demon. Muhammad himself agree in the Quran, agree in the Hadith, that Muhammad is possessed for the Muslim, they say he's a genie. Genie is not a demon, by the way. But let us say, obviously, it was a demon. So Muhammad, he says that Allah helped him against his genie, Shaitan, and he command him to do good. Let us find the Hadith. Have you ever heard of a prophet? He admit that he received command from the devil, Shaitan. This is Sahih Muslim, Hadith number 28148. None is among you is whom would not attach with amongst of the jinn, the devil. They the companion, they said, Allah Messenger, would you too? Whereupon he said, yes, yes, I got one too, very handsome. Help, but Allah help me against him, so I am safe from his hands, and he does not command me but for good. In Matthew chapter 10, you will see that this is an evil spirit. According to Islam, evil spirit. Even your own translation use the word the devil. Do you see it? This is your Muslim website. So Muhammad receiving command from the devil, while Jesus, he gave his disciple in Matthew, the one you are quoting for us, the power of casting out any clean spirit, demon. Muhammad, he have no power over them. Now, if Jesus is not God, how he can give power to me? How you can give something you don't have? You have no authority over it. Let us say God, he gave, as Muslim they claim that Jesus is not God, he's just a prophet. Okay, we will go with the argument. So he is a prophet, God sponsor him with miracle. How Jesus can share the power which God gave to him? That is impossible. So Jesus, he gave them command to go out and heal. The disciple of Jesus, and actually this is what it says in Ibn Kathir and many Islamic books, that disciple of Jesus, they did a lot of miracles and they healed many. Heal of all manner, they have power over everything. All manner, no disease can stop them. No sickness can overcome them. And they did. And then you will see, when this guy says to us in the video, go and read chapter 10, verse number 4. Why the Abdur, he did not want us to read the verses before, for simply embarrassing. Actually, what he said for number 4? Is that 4? I don't know. It says 4. Abdul. Okay, let's go. Okay, he's saying it's 4. What 4? I do not even know how to quote any. Anyway, so those 12 disciples, they were sent forth, and they've been command, and he commanded them, go into the way of the Gentiles. And here you get busted again, because you Muslim claim that Jesus was sent only to the Jews. And you said that in the previous video. So shame on you that you are stupid at the point you search Google to find something, article made by Muslims, copy-paste. But here it says that Jesus, he sent us, all of us, to teach everybody. No exception. And then he says, I don't know if this guy is worth it actually to speak about him. You know, heal the sickness, cleanse the leper, raise the dead. Jesus, he gave them the power to raise the dead. Cast out the devil. Freely you have received, freely you have given. And that's why today we give, you know, our free book for people in Indonesia for free. Right? For free. Free you give. Free. If you can give it for free, give it for free. Again, if you did not receive my book, Deception of Allah, free translation in your language, Indonesian language, please feel free to download the link from underneath of the video. All right? So when the Muhammadan, they try to give us a verse from the Bible, they fail always because first they misquote. Second, they don't even know how to quote the numbers. Number three, they don't understand the meaning. And the funny, those Muslims don't understand the verse in the Quran, yet they want to explain to us a verse in the Bible. So by quoting that chapter, you just prove to me that Jesus is God. Right? This is what the whole chapter is saying. The whole chapter confirmed to us that Jesus is God. Let us listen more.
The first, Simon, who is called Peter, and Andrew his brother, James the son of Zebedee, and John his brother, Philip and Bartholomew, Thomas, and Matthew the publican, James the son of Alphaeus, and Lebbaeus, whose surname was Thaddeus, Simon the Canaanite, and Judas Iscariot, who also betrayed him. These 12 Jesus sent forth, and commanded them, saying, Go not into the way of the Gentiles, and into any city of the Samaritans enter ye not, but go rather to the lost sheep of the house of Israel.
Yeah, actually here he would say, oh, it says here that you go only to Gentiles. The fact here, this is in the beginning, he sent them to the people of Israel, and later he told them, I have sheep in the other place, so go everywhere and teach and etc. and reach everybody. So here they will say to you, oh, you just said that Jesus, he said, he sent us to everybody, but the verse is saying no. No, this is just here in the beginning. Start with the Jews. This is where your base, because all of them, they are Jews. Start with your people, and then you go out to the Gentile. Later after Jesus, he said, and Jesus himself, he went to the Gentile. Let's see.
And as ye go, preach, saying, the kingdom of heaven is at hand. Heal the sick, cleanse the lepers, raise the dead, cast out devils. Freely ye have received, freely give. Provide neither gold nor silver, nor brass in your purses, nor scrip for your journey, neither two coats, neither shoes, nor yet staves, for the workman is worthy of his meat. And into whatsoever city or town ye shall enter, inquire who in it is worthy, and there abide till ye go thence. And when ye come into an house, salute it. And if the house be worthy, let your peace come upon it. But if it be not worthy, let your peace return to you. And whosoever shall not receive you, nor hear your words, when ye depart out of that house or city, shake off the dust of your feet. Verily I say unto you, it shall be more tolerable for the land of Sodom and Gomorrah in the day of judgment than for that city. Behold, I send you forth as sheep in the midst of wolves. Be ye therefore wise as serpents.
Exactly what happened to us Christians. Muhammad, he unleashed his wolves. He says, go and kill the Christians and the Jews. Chapter 9, verse number 23. Chapter 9, 29. So, Jesus told us, you will be like a sheep between wolves. You know how sheep, they suffer between wolves? They rip them off pieces. This is exactly what Jesus, he predicted would happen to them. And this is exactly what happened to them.
And harmless as doves. But beware of men, for they will deliver you up to the councils, and they will scourge you in their synagogues. And ye shall be brought before governors and kings for my sake, for a testimony against them and the Gentiles. But when they deliver you up, take no thought how or what ye shall speak, for it shall be given you in that same hour what ye shall speak. For it is not ye that speak, but the Spirit of your Father which speaketh in you. And the brother shall deliver up the brother to death, and the father the child. And the children shall rise up against their parents, and cause them to be put to death. And ye shall be hated of all men for my name's sake. But he that endureth to the end shall be saved. But when they persecute you in this city, flee ye into another. For verily I say unto you, ye shall not have gone over the cities of Israel till the Son of Man be come. The disciple is not above his master, nor the servant above his lord. It is enough for the disciple that he be as his master, and the servant as his lord. If they have called the master of the house Beelzebub, how much more shall they call them of his household? Fear them not, therefore, for there is nothing covered that shall not be revealed, and hid that shall not be known. What I tell you in darkness, that speak ye in the light, and what ye hear in the ear, that preach ye upon the housetops. And fear not them which kill the body, but are not able to kill the soul, but rather fear him which is able to destroy both soul and body in hell. Are not two sparrows sold for a farthing? And one of them shall not fall on the ground without your Father. but the very hairs of your head are all numbered. Fear ye not, therefore, ye are of more value than many sparrows. Whosoever therefore shall confess me before men, him will I confess also before my Father which is in heaven. But whosoever shall deny me before men, him will I also deny before my Father which is in heaven. Think not that I am come to send peace on earth. I came not to send peace, but a sword. For I am come to set a man at variance against his father.
See here, the Muslim, they quote this verse for you already. They say, Jesus, he came with a sword. The fact here, the sword is explained. He's saying to you that you will be having trouble with the people. People will kill you. People will hate you in my name. This is the sword. The Muslim, they misquote this verse always, lying, saying this is Jesus came with doing jihad. But okay, Jesus, did Jesus kill anybody? No. All right.
And the daughter against her mother, and the daughter-in-law against her mother-in-law. And a man's foe shall be they of his own household. He that loveth father or mother more than me is not worthy of me, and he that loveth son or daughter more than me is not worthy of me. And he that taketh not his cross and followeth after me is not worthy of me. He that findeth his life shall lose it, and he that loseth his life for my sake shall find it. He that receiveth you receiveth me, and he that receiveth me receiveth him that sent me. He that receiveth a prophet in the name of a prophet shall receive a prophet's reward, and he that receiveth a righteous man in the name of a righteous man shall receive a righteous man's reward. And whosoever shall give to drink unto one of these little ones a cup of cold water only in the name of a disciple, verily I say unto you, he shall in no wise lose his reward.
Beautiful teaching, very high standard of knowledge, and let us say logic. When we read the Quran, we see nothing but somebody trying to make rabbi music. Stupid, there's no teaching there. There's nothing. No spiritual, nothing real. It's fake. Same time, when the Muslim, they try to quote for us something from the Bible, and you are trying supposedly to correct us, to show us that we will not go to heaven. And you yourself, you are not going to go to heaven. If we go in the hadith, you will see the hypocrisy of those people who call themselves Muslims. We will find the following. And by the way, if a Muslim will say to you, okay, so here Jesus says, don't go to the Gentile first. This is about, mission and order. First you go here, second you go there. Later we will find that even Jesus himself, he went to the Gentile and he spoke to them. As an example, in the same book of Matthew, chapter number 15, verse number 22, right? And you will see there he made a miracle, and he accepted the Gentile to be a believer. And we can read the same. You can go to Luke 7. You can go to 1 John. There's many places speaking about this issue. So, and Jesus said, go and teach the whole, you know, go and teach and preach the whole world. For God, he loved the world. He sent his only begotten son, the world, not only the Jews. But I want to show something here. Give me a second. If we go to the Quran, we will find this. Sorry. In chapter 7, verse number 99, the Muslim, they have false translation. Let us see if we can get more honest translation. Maybe, you never know. Which one? I don't know, all of them, they are liars, but we can try something else. Yeah. Devising. I didn't know what he meant by devising. Hold on. Yeah, this is false translation. You see, in Arabic it says that you should. Are you going to trust Allah, who is the deceiver? Are you know, you should believe for the deception of Allah. If you want to be secure from the deception of Allah, nobody can be secure from the deception of Allah. And those who think they can be secure, those are the losers. And in translation, it says something totally different. Feel secure against God? Do you feel secure? It doesn't say that. It says, do you feel secure against the deception of God? Allah is the deceiver, and you cannot feel secure from him. Let us change the translation. Maybe we can get something better. What language is that? See here, this is how the Muslim, by the way, those who claim to speak Arabic, they read this. You see those words? Those are like making the sound of the Arabic Quran. أَفَيُؤْمِنُونَ مَكْرَ اللَّهِ مَكْرَ. So he claimed that he is reading Quran, but he don't know. He's reading this. This is how they fool you. You think that, okay, he knew the Quran. Look, he is reading Arabic. The fact he is just reading words written in his own letters to make it sound like. Let us see. Maybe we try this one. No, secure against Allah plan. I mean, do you see this deception? This is why I call my book Deception of Allah, because it says deception. Here they say secure against the plan of Allah when it's about deception. So there is a statement where they ask, are you secure from the deception of Allah? He said, I am not. لا آمن مكر الله. I cannot trust. I cannot feel safe from the deception of Allah. Let me see if I can find it for you so we can see what Umar al-Khattabi says. And I will give you an example of the deception of Allah, which is very troubling, by the way. Oh, I cannot find it in English. Let me see if I can find something else. This is the problem when not everybody speaks Arabic, you know. All right. Let us see this one. I'm just trying to find something I can show in English. Otherwise, I have tons of reference in Arabic. This one, we cannot find it. But anyway, even if we don't have it in English, we can do this. Give me a second. Because it doesn't show reference, just show statement. I want to show reference. I don't want to say things without proofs. All right. This is here. We have some reference. And I will click translate to English. Here, and the Muslim, they will say to you, by the way, let us use something else, because they will say to you, this is da'if, and you know, etc., that's not proven. Let us show you something more proven, so they cannot play games with it, because the whole purpose, you know, the Muslims, they bounce like a ball. You give them something, they play with it. Oh, this is a da'if. Oh, this is not accepted. Oh, we, you know, okay. Let us see. Here we go. How they can escape this one? Can they? Let us see. This is Sahih al-Bukhari. You see, the other hadith is not Bukhari, so they will play games with it. This one is very solid. They cannot get away from it in any way, in any mean. Muhammad here, he claimed that when you are created, Allah, he wrote your destiny. He wrote your provision, your age, whether you will be evil or you will be good. This is your destiny. It's not you that's decided. It's Allah, he decided for you. And he decides for you where you will go. You will go to heaven or to hell. Read with me carefully. It says, Muhammad, he says, and by Allah, a person among you, or a man, may do the deeds of the people of fire, till there is only a cubit or an arm, a distance between him and this hellfire. So this guy is doing all his life evil work, supposedly, which means like he's being nice to the Christians, he's taking them as a friends, which is again the Quran chapter 5 verse 51. He is not killing the Christians, which is against the Quran teaching to kill the Christians, chapter 9 verse 29, etc. So if you are an evil person who is not killing Christians and not refusing them as a friends and being good to them or honoring them, that's meaning you will go to hell. So this person is doing act of hell all the way until almost he is going to go inside the hell. He's in the door, in the front. And then what will happen? And then, then that is written, which Allah has ordered the angel to write, which means his destiny. Proceed, and he does the deeds of people of paradise. This is deception. Do you see the deception? So Muslim been ordered to do this and this and this and this, and then what Allah he wrote is going to take over. You know what I mean? Do you see why we cannot trust Allah? Allah, he ordered you to do the following. As an example, to pray 5 times a day. Read the second example with me. The second example fit with this praying 5 times a day. And then he says, and a man may do the deeds of people of paradise till there's only a cubit or a tooth between him and paradise. Okay, so he prayed 5 times a day. He fast Ramadan. He killed the Christians. He raped their women. He stole their property. He called them all kinds of names. He hate everybody except Islam and Muslims. And now he is ready to go to heaven. Look what will happen. Then, that what is written, proceed that he does the deeds of people of fire and enter it. That is the top deception on the world. So he order you to do things and you do it. As you see, he says he is doing the deeds of people who enter paradise. Do you see it? But then that is written will take over. And he does the deeds of people of paradise, you know. And then the opposite, a man who may do the deeds of paradise, and then when it's time to go to paradise, Allah, what he wrote for him, he forces him by this destiny, he starts doing what Allah he wrote for him. That is deception. You promise us we will go to heaven if we believe in you. You promise us if we pray 5 times, if we do kill Christians and Jews, kill Hindus, we go to heaven. And now we found that it's at the end of the day, it is what is written, not what we do. Do you see it? Let's continue with the joker. Sorry, we skipped. Why we are doing this? By mistake. Where we are, where we stop.
Father in heaven wants them to do. A question to you, Christian Prince. Have you ever done anything according to the...
Yeah, we answered this one. Let us pass. Sorry, by mistake, we clicked the bar. Let us go. Okay.
17, verse number 3. Jesus said, an eternal life means to know you, the only true God, and to know Jesus Christ, whom you sent. Christian Prince, Jesus said that Allah was the only true...
You see here, the liars here, they always insert Allah, 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 where Jesus says the word Allah. They will say to you in Arabic translation or Bible translation, in Indonesian language, they use the word Allah. This is a false translation. The word Allah never exists in the Bible, period. So stop lying, you filthy liar. Secondly, as long you agree with this chapter you quote for me, let us see what chapter he's quoting for me, so we can laugh.
Prince, Jesus said that Allah was the only true God, and he was whom you sent.
But
in chapter number 17, verse number 3.
So, what chapter, Muslims? John chapter 17. Let us go to John chapter 17. And you will see how right away he will regret quoting that chapter. And here you see the stupidity of those who fight Christianity, how stupid they are. Read carefully. Verse number 1, which he don't want to read for you. Actually, let us hear it better.
John 17. These words spake Jesus, and lifted up his eyes to heaven, and said, Father, the hour is come. Glorify thy Son, that thy Son also may glorify thee, as thou hast given him.
Hold on. Guys, did you see the hypocrisy of this idiot? He is quoting for us a chapter to prove to us that Jesus is not God. Right? He quoted a verse. He skipped the first verse in the same chapter. Why? Because the first verse in the chapter get him busted. So the Father glorified the Son, and the Son glorified the Father. Okay, hold on. If Jesus is not God, and he is just a human like me, why the Father, who is God, glorifying a man? You know what I mean? Anyone can explain to us? Why the Father is glorifying a man? He is a man, right? He's just a man. No, he's glorifying the Son, not a man. And you see here the glorify of the Son is the glorify of the Father, and glorify of the Father is the glorify of the Son. So you just get yourself busted saying that Jesus is not God. The same chapter, the same verse, it says that Jesus is, to the point that even the Father glorify him. And then it says, let us continue.
Power over all flesh, that he should give eternal life to as many as thou hast given him.
Okay. He have what? The Son of the Father, who is God. He been given power over all flesh. Why you did not quote for us that? Did Muhammad have power over all the flesh? They would say no. Muhammad himself, he is not sure if Allah will forgive his sin or not. Even Allah is not sure. Here we go. If we go in the Quran, you will find the following. Chapter 48, verse number 2. It says that Allah may forgive your sin. Jesus forgives sin. He have the power over the flesh, over all mankind, over everything. So even Allah, he is not sure. Muhammad here, this is Muhammad is saying Allah said to him. What Allah said to him? May Allah forgive your sin. Here you can prove to us from this that Allah cannot be God, because if Allah is saying to me, Allah can forgive your sin, who is the one who's talking? Do you know this, guys? If I am God and I am talking, I should say, your sin is forgiven. This is what Jesus said. Go, he said to the Jews, which one is easier, to say carry your bed or your sin is forgiven? Talk is cheap. I can say that too. I can say, okay, your sin is forgiven, but this doesn't mean it make me God. So Jesus, he proved it. He said to them, which one is easier to do? Carry your bed, the guy who cannot walk all his life. Carry your bed and walk, showing them the authority of God of the flesh. And he have the authority of God as God over sin. Which one is easier to say to him, your sin is forgiven, or carry your bed and walk? And he did both. Here the God of Muhammad, he cannot even be sure if he can forgive or not. May Allah forgive ye the sin of the past and the one to come. Open license for sin. I understand the past. What about the one to come? So the Quran is an evil book. Muhammad here trying to get a license from his God, saying, I can do sin to come and may Allah forgive me. But this is cannot be God talking, because if God is talking, he is sure he will forgive or not. Here it says me. So if we go back in the Bible, which this guy is trying to quote for us, we will find right away that he is misquoting plain and he is a hypocrite man. Why you skip the whole chapter going all the way to the end and you did not read those? Because those will not benefit him. Will prove the opposite. And then, and this is the eternal life. The idiot, he is the one who quote for us saying that the eternal life is to believe in one God. But he just said, here it says, that the eternal life is what? Read carefully.
And this is life eternal, that they might know thee, the only true God, and Jesus Christ, whom thou hast sent.
So what is the eternal life? That God, he glorified the Son, and the Son glorified the Father. What is the eternal life? That he being given power over the flesh, and he is the one who should give eternal life to many. That's mean the eternal life is Jesus and believing in Jesus. And all what Jesus is saying to them, because they see a man in front of them, well, the man in front of you, he can do nothing of himself. It's a flesh. But I am the Son of God. So I am God in flesh of a man. The man can do nothing. But what you see is the man, which is God, is in the flesh. This is why the Bible says that God, he humbled himself. He came to us in the image of a humble man. He humbled himself. So this liar, he quoted for us a verse trying to play with it when the verse is saying the opposite of what he claimed. Let's continue a little bit.
I have glorified thee on the earth. I have finished the work which thou gavest me to do. And now, O Father, glorify thou me with thine own self, with the glory which I had with thee before the world was.
Hold on. I mean, do you see the disaster, guys? Jesus, he had a glory with the Father before the world was. Do you see it? People, do you see it? Muslims, do you see how those liars who claim that they have answers for you, they are lying? What is the dignity? There is no way that this guy, he was able to read verse number 3, but he did not see the verse after it. And now the Father glorified thou me. And I was with the Father, with his glory and my glory with him, before the whole universe was exist. Jesus was exist before the whole world is exist. How come he did not see it? The answer is very simple. He knew, he saw it. But he is a potato. He's what? He's a potato. Coward. No dignity. Never learn.
Glorify thou me with thine own. Glorify thou me with thine own.
Never learn the Bible from a Muslim. They don't even know, they don't even know their book. Number two, they lie. Number three, they are permitted to lie. Number four, Islam is deception and Allah is the beast of deceivers. So the whole game here is a game of deceiving, not teaching.
Glorify thou me with thine own self, with the glory which I had with thee before the world was. I have manifested thy name unto the men which thou gavest me out of the world. Thine they were, and thou gavest them me, and they have kept thy word. Now they have known that all things whatsoever thou hast given me are of thee. For I have given unto them the words which thou gavest me, and they have received them, and have known surely that I came out from thee, and they have believed that thou didst send me. I pray for them. I pray not for the world, but for them which thou hast given me, for they are thine, and all mine are thine, and thine are mine, and I am glorified in them. And now I am no more in the world, but these are in the world, and I come to thee. Holy Father, keep through thine own name those whom thou hast given me, that they may be one, as we are. While I was with them in the world, I kept them in thy...
I mean, do you see? If we continue, I mean, this chapter is amazing, actually. I advise you all to read it, because that will explore to us how liars they are. That all they be one, as though Father art in me, and I in thee. I mean, what do you want more? And this potato, he's trying to show us verses from the Bible saying Jesus is not God. We laugh at you. Every Indonesian will laugh at you now. You are just a fool and a liar.
According to the Gospel of John chapter 9.
Let's escape because this is getting long, you know. I mean, this guy is just saying nothing. Let us say.
He was just only the messenger of...
See the cover? The same chapter saying that Jesus was with God before the earth, with his Father, before the whole world was created. And the Father, he glorified him. And he is the Son of God. And he's saying, Jesus said, I'm just a messenger.
Allah.
And Allah too, not only Father.
It means that Jesus is not God.
See, that's it. I mean, the whole book of John, from the beginning, from verse number one, it says that Jesus is God, you idiot. And it says, John, saying Jesus is not God. You see, I mean, those idiots, they are amazing. This is the book of John. If we go from the first page ever in the book of John, just the first one, from the beginning, it says Jesus is God. In the beginning, the Word was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. And who is that Word? Read carefully. Listen carefully. Crazy people, liars.
The Gospel according to John, chapter 1. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. The same was in the beginning with God. All things were made by him, and without him was not anything made that was made.
Everything made by him. The book of John saying everything was created by Jesus. And this potato saying to us, the book of James saying Jesus is just a messenger. The first page of the book of John. The first few letters of the book of John saying everything was made by him. Who? Jesus. Do you have dignity? Do you have any shame? You don't.
There was not anything made that was made. In him was life, and the life was the light of men. And the light shineth in darkness, and the darkness comprehended it not. There was a man sent from God, whose name was John. The same came for a witness to bear witness of the light, that all men through him might believe. He was not that light, but was sent to bear witness of that light. That was the true light, which lighteth every man that cometh into the world. He was...
So there is a person, his name is John, this is John, and I am a person here to share the light with you, the light of God. Who is the light of God? Who is that God? Let us see.
In the world, and the world was made by him, and the world knew him not.
And the word is what? Is made by him. Who? Jesus.
Came unto his own, and his own received him not. But as many as received him, to them gave he power to become the sons of God.
Do you see it? So he came to his people, the Israeli, and they receive him not. So he gave power to those who ever receive him.
Even to them that believe on his name, which were born not of blood, nor of the will of the flesh, nor of the will of man, but of God. And the Word was made flesh, and dwelt among us, and we beheld his glory, the glory as of the only begotten of the Father, full of grace and truth.
Do you see it? So who is the Word, which in the beginning says, in the beginning the Word is God, that is Jesus. So the liar, when he quote for us anything, we laugh at you. You're a joker, you're stupid. And actually, the reason I decide to play your video, you notice here not putting my name in the title, trying to avoid me. You notice that? Like in the video speaking to Christian Prince, but he did not put my name in the title, so I will not see it. He will not notice it. Nobody will notice that, okay, this is, I'm talking to Christian Prince, so Christian Prince will send me the video and say, spank him, right? I think it's enough to laugh at this guy for today. I might go live on air again soon later. I don't know, guys. It's, we have only 1,137 in my side watching. Do we have any Muslim here? We have Imam Murrah. How are you, Imam Murrah? Imam Murrah, what do you think about Yasser Kadri? He is going to be refuted by Mimi Hijab. Guys, now Mimi Hijab is going to refute Yasser Kadri. Imagine this crazy madness cult. A second ago he was his teacher. A second after he wanna refute him. A brother and sister, we welcome Dr. Sheikh Yasser Kadri. Okay, so he was a sheikh, he was a doctor a second before. When Yasser Kadri, he says, we have holes. How many holes you have? Holes. Muslims could not take it. Suddenly, Yasser Kadri is not a sheikh. Suddenly, Yasser Kadri is sent by Christian Prince. So I will make a video about it. Let us see. Did we do it tomorrow or later? Maybe we should do it tomorrow. he is Indonesian. He wants to call me. Who is this Indonesian when I call me? Who is this Indonesian when I call me? Okay, we will take a call. Give me a second to open Skype. Okay. All right. Let us see. Man, standing for long, it hurt. I mean, sitting for long, sorry. All right, where is the Muslim who wanna call me? Universal Dawah? Oh, we have a guy, his name is Universal Dawah, all right. You hang up. Universal Dawah, I'm calling you, my friend. You are not online? Yeah, let Imam Murrah call so we can have fun. Hello?
Hello?
Yes, Mr. Universal Dawah, how are you?
Can you hear me?
Yeah, but your voice somehow is not clear. Can you? I don't know what's the problem. Go ahead.
Can you hear me now?
I hear you. Go ahead. What do you want to say?
You want to ask me a question about Christianity?
Oh, you want to know about Christianity? You don't want to know about Islam?
I want to ask you a question.
You don't want to know about Islam? Hold on, hold on. Let me. I mean, I'm trying to find out why your sound is bad. Hold on.
Why is it only? Yeah. Why is it only always offensive on Islam?
What?
Can you not defend your religion?
What?
Why is it only always offensive on Islam? Can you not defend your religion?
Well, what does have to do with defending my religion? I am showing you Islam is a stupid religion. So in order to show you, so I have no right to show you Islam is a stupid. Okay, let me ask you, let me ask you. So if you see somebody, I will go with your logic. Why Muhammad cannot concentrate in his religion, but he attacked Christianity? So how come he can do what we cannot? He said that Christians are wrong. He said the Christians will go to hell. He said the Christians are kuffar. So how come your prophet, he can do it, but we cannot do it? Don't you think you are a hypocrite now?
So is it not a way to start conversation about Islam?
What?
So you are just tricking now. You are just tricking now.
I'm what?
You are tricking now because you are just trying to start a conversation about Islam by asking about the prophet.
Okay, so okay, I want you to help me. You see, maybe I'm wrong as you are saying. Correct me. What I should do? Teach me what I should do from now on when I go live on air. What I should do?
Can ask me about.
No.
Can I ask you about Christianity now?
Sure, no problem. But I want you to tell me, what do you want me to do from now on? What do you like me to do so you will be happy? Because I don't want to make you angry.
Talk to me about Christianity.
Huh?
Talk to me about Christianity.
Teach about Christianity. Okay, I will teach you about Christianity. Let me teach you about Christianity. Jesus said there's false prophet, they will come watch for them. So we are watching for Muhammad. Here we go.
But I did not ask a question now.
No problem, but you said you should teach about Christianity. Jesus said, watch for false prophet, false teachers who will come to you in a clothes of a wolf. Huh? What? Hello? Turn off your camera. I mean, why you are showing me your camera and your, what is that? Turn off your camera. This guy, he don't even have good internet, and he is turning the camera for me. He's not answering. Yeah, maybe his internet is bad. It's okay. Do we have another Muslim? Hey, Imam Murrah, man, what are you? Call us. We need the love. Yes, sir. Okay. We have a Muslim trying to call. None of them is answering. Hello?
Hello?
Yes, my friend. Turn off your camera, please. And tell me what you
are. Yes, what should I tell you?
I don't know. You are the one who called me. I have missed calls from you. You are calling me for what reason?
Yes, this is true. Because I wanted to debate with you.
All right.
So the first question, yes, the first question was, is what's the topic today?
Oh, the topic today, that Muhammad is a fraud.
Okay, and how can you How can you prove that he is a fraud?
Well, give me anything he told you and I will prove it to be fraud. Give me, here you go. It's an open challenge for you with my, in a friendly way. Give me anything Muhammad he said and I will prove that it is wrong and it's false. Go ahead. Anything.
Yes, for example, he said that Muslims should do something like zakat. This means to spend money to the poor people.
Hmm. So this is what Muhammad taught you? Okay. First of all, the word zakat is not an Arabic, it's a Hebrew word, and that means Muhammad is a thief, because the Quran says that the Quran is a pure Arabic. وَجَعَلْنَاهُ قُرْآنًا عَرَبِيًّا. So this is a pure Arabic, but zakat is not an Arabic word. Secondly, what is a zakat pay according to Muhammad?
I don't exactly know, but I think it depends on how much money you have.
No. See, the funny that in the Bible it says that you have to pay the zakat, which is 10%. Muhammad never said how much, so it is really stupid. What does that mean? As an example, if you go around the Kaaba 7 times, is the same as freeing a slave. So you do not need to do anything. Now go around the Kaaba and kiss the black stone, and that's it. You are done. So you do not even need to feed the poor. Do you have to feed the poor, or you just go around the Kaaba?
No, I don't think. I don't think so. I think you have to go around the Kaaba, but I don't know. I don't exactly know.
What do you mean?
I think we should do both of them.
Okay, we should do both, but isn't okay. You see, I don't know how much you know about your prophet. But when your prophet, he says, if you do go around the Kaaba, is the same as doing etc. That's mean you do not need to do it. You know, go around the Kaaba. It's a better choice. It's easier choice.
Yes, this is true. It's easy. It's easier when you go around the Kaaba.
Okay, so what is the charity? How this can be charity? You go around the Kaaba a few times, and that is better than giving money to the poor?
No, I don't think it's better. I think when you give money to the poor, this is better than going around the Kaaba. Hmm. But I don't know. Both of them is good. But I think if you give money to poor people, this is better.
Okay, so are you agreeing that Muhammad is wrong when he says that?
But I don't think that he is wrong because when he says that going around the Kaaba is just like giving money to the poor, I think this is a reason behind this, and I think Allah knows why it's the same.
Okay, so what?
But I think so what
does that mean? I mean, why I have to go around the Kaaba, and that will be better than feeding the poor? How that can be not wrong? Which one, the Kaaba need food, the Kaaba, so what you do when you go around the Kaaba? Nothing. I mean, what is that? This is a pagan practice. The Arab, they used to go around the Kaaba, and they used to go to practice this, and even they used to kiss and worship the black stone, as Muhammad, he did.
Yes, When people do this, I think that this is a good good deeds that they do.
Okay,
but I don't know
how it is good deed by going around the stone and kissing a stone. How that can be a good deed?
I don't know.
What you are the one who's saying to me, it's a good deed.
Yes, it may be a good deed because maybe Allah said that we should do this, and this is why it's a good deed. But I don't know why, but Allah knows why it's good. I don't
you
know.
see the hadith in front of us on the screen. I don't know if you can see it. It says that the one who touched the stone, the black stone and the Yemeni corner, Allah, oh sorry, the black stone will erase his sin. How a black stone will erase your sin? Or let us say Allah will erase your sin. As the Muslims say, they will say, oh, it's Allah will erase your sin. So how touching a stone will erase your sin, and feeding the poor will not erase your sin? Because still you have to ask Allah for forgiveness, etc. Here you just go, touch the stone, kiss it, touch the Yemeni corner, which have stones from Yemen, from the temple of Makkah. And then your sin is erased. How that can happen?
Yes, I don't know. I don't know how this can happen.
Okay, do you understand that going around and believing in a stones, those is literally, not metaphorically, that by touching them, don't you think that this is a pagan practice? What do you think? Okay, you have bad internet. Are you there? Look like we lost him. Hello? I don't know. Bad internet. What we can do? We are reconnecting. Let us call him again. I will put the speakers down so he will not annoy us, the sound. So guys, look at this logic. Muhammad, he says, pay zakat. And this is an order from the Old Testament, not from Islam. And how you pay zakat? You go and attack your neighbors, the Christians and the Jews. You take their money. You give some money to the poor and keep 99% of it to your pocket. And that is supposedly will make you a good person. Hello? That answer. Let us see the first one. We lost him. Universal Dawah, his name. Universal Dawah. This guy is professional. He do Dawah. Yes, Universal. Speak louder, please. Speak louder. Okay, what do you want to say? Go ahead. Yeah, I hear you, but the sound is not good. I don't know why. You need to get close to the microphone. Go ahead.
Can you not hear
clearly? Yeah, okay, now I hear you better. Okay, go ahead.
So, can I ask you a question about Christianity?
Sure, go ahead.
So, this flesh of Jesus died on cross, right?
Okay.
Do you agree?
Just give me the question, don't me now. We are not kids, my friend. Give me the question.
Yeah. So, was flesh of Jesus a part of Trinity?
Part of what?
Trinity.
Part of his deity? Okay, this is a good question, actually. I want you to listen carefully. Guys, this guy is saying.
Flesh of Jesus a,
okay, sounds.
Was flesh of
okay.
Jesus a part of Trinity?
So, I want to ask you first, do you think that the flesh of Jesus is part of the deity or not? What do you think?
I think no.
No. Okay, so how you answer this? Your God Allah, He have a flesh, and you just said,
Again.
hold on, hold on,
Again,
hold
what?
on, hold on, hold on. You see, because we have to connect the dots. You are a Muslim, I'm a Christian, so we have put both together and see how stupid what you just said. You just agreed that Allah, He is inside the flesh, which is not from His deity. So Allah can go
Also,
inside His
what
creation.
I did not hear clearly. What?
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 I thought
Allah,
you asked.
what? Hold on, hold on.
I thought you said if you are. I thought you asked if Jesus, flesh of Jesus was part of deity or not.
Yes, you are the one who asked the question, not me. I said to you, do you agree? Is it part or not? You said, no, it's not. Okay, so now what do you want to say else next? Go ahead.
Yeah, it's not.
Okay, and what?
So, if flesh of Jesus was not a part of deity, so no one from deity died for your sins, right?
Okay, so and what does that mean? If the flesh of Jesus is not the deity, that is not the okay, what does that mean?
I mean, flesh of Jesus is not a part of deity, and flesh died for your sins, so no one from deity died for your sins,
Okay.
right?
So and what does that mean?
That means no one from Father, Son, and Holy Spirit died for your sins.
Okay, but what the flesh of Jesus have to do now with the Trinity? I'm trying to understand. What does the flesh have to do with the Trinity? Still, Jesus is Jesus. God is one, and God, He came to us in a flesh
Yeah.
of a man. In the front of you will see that
What?
Allah, He come to you in a shape, maybe shape of an octopus, a goat, we do not know. So Allah will come to you in a
Okay,
shape.
okay.
Is that shape is part of Allah or it's not part
Yeah,
of Allah?
so.
Huh?
So Jesus has two natures, right?
What?
Flesh and human. Yeah, flesh and divine.
Flesh and divine. Well, this is how He came to us, yes.
Yeah.
And?
So and flesh is not a part of Trinity.
And who
So no
said?
one from Trinity
Okay,
died
hold
for
on,
your
hold on,
sins.
hold on, hold on. The flesh is not part of a Trinity. What does that mean exactly?
That means flesh is not a part of, it's not connected to Trinity.
Who said so?
I asked you, you said yes.
I did not say anything. I said, okay, I'm listening to you.
Okay. So what do you think? Is it yes or
You
no?
see, when God, He came to us in a flesh of a man, that God is in that man, so that the flesh in that moment is God in that man. As simple as that. So
Yeah, so
Jesus the
is
man,
it part of
Jesus
deity
the
or
hold
no?
on, Jesus
So
the
is it
man,
part of
hold on,
deity or no?
Jesus the man, He is
I'm not
God.
sure.
Let me answer you. So Jesus the God, who is Jesus the man, is the same person. There's no two person there. You are assuming that there's two person. No, it's one person. So when you say the flesh is part, are you talking about cutting the flesh of meat? Jesus is the flesh. He is the flesh, and He is the Son of God. So He came to us, and He said, "Before Abraham, I am." So His birth. Hold on. So His
So I'm
birth.
trying to say
So His birth had nothing to do with His existence, for He was exist before He came to us in the flesh of a man. He was the Word of God. So when God in the flesh of the man, yes, that the flesh of the man is God in that the flesh of the man. So you cannot say part or not part. This is not a game. This is not a piece of a cheese. You take it from here, you put it there. So you are misleading yourself, fooling yourself. Your God Allah, He come to Moses in a tree. Was the tree part of the flesh of Allah or it's not?
No, he talked through that tree.
No, he did not. If you see, here we go. Let's see, let's show everybody. Everybody will laugh at you. The tree spoke and says, "I am Allah."
But you are the only one who is laughing now.
No, here we go. Let's see. Everybody will read. I want you to read the verse for me. Can you see?
Yeah, everyone in your live stream is laughing, so they
My
are laughing at
my
you.
friend, can you read the verse for me?
I'm not seeing the verse now.
Oh, you want me to show you the
I can't
verse?
see
Okay,
it.
here we go. This is the
I
verse.
can't see it.
Okay.
I'm not seeing your live stream now. I'm on
Okay.
Skype.
Okay. So the voice came, you are the one who said the voice came from the tree,
So,
right?
don't you want to talk about Christianity?
Okay, now we're talking about Christianity now. We're talking about how God, he act. So when Allah, He spoke from the tree, He was the tree or He was a bird in the tree?
Was talking through the tree?
Through the tree. So the tree,
Okay,
okay, thank you guys. Did you hear it? So Allah, He spoke through the tree. So the tree was talking, but it's Allah.
No. You are talking through your mobile now.
No,
So is your
okay.
mobile talking or you
Okay,
talking?
so the
Who's
tree,
talking now?
so
But you
okay,
said
so the
mobile
tree,
talking.
okay, hold on, okay. But he says, "I am Allah." The tree said, "I am Allah," by speaking from the tree. The tree is a piece of technology now. So you are saying to me, look how funny what you say. The tree is the same as a cell phone according to you. And now Allah is using the tree to speak from the tree, and this is his cell phone. Who in the world would believe in such a garbage? Secondly, I want you to show me one Islamic scholar agree with you that no, I want you to show me one Islamic scholar agree with you that the tree of Allah was the phone of Allah. Allah was not there. Because if you read with me, it says, hold on. Okay, it says,
give you an analogy.
Okay, analogy, no problem. It says, when he reached the fire, was called from the right side of the valley in the blessed place. Why it's a blessed that place? The location is the blessed. Why? Is Allah there or not there?
It's blessed because Allah talked through it.
But he did not talk yet. But he did not, okay. But is the sound of Allah. Okay, hold on. So if Allah spoke that...
Hold on.
So you are saying to me, if Allah spoke, that will make the whole land there holy? Or only that spot?
Only that part, because Allah...
Okay, so why that spot? Okay, so why that spot only? Why that spot only? Is that because Allah exists there, or his voice was exist there?
Through it.
Huh?
Yeah, because Allah took through it, not the whole...
Okay, so now we have a new Kaaba. It's called the holy tree, for this is the holy spot of Allah, the only place Allah spoke from. Allah never spoke from the Kaaba. And Allah never went to the Kaaba, and Allah never touched the Kaaba, but Allah, he was in the top of the tree. So you Muslims, if you are decent, you should go find that tree and go around the Kaaba and bow down to the tree, because this is your God. For God, your God, he says to you that this is a holy spot, and he is there in the tree, as you are saying to me, and you are confirming to me that this is a holy spot, for Allah was speaking from there.
I said it's a blessed spot.
Okay, why it's a blast? Why it's a blast?
Because the Prophet was there and Allah talked through it.
No, the Prophet, he did not even touch it. The Prophet, he did not touch the tree.
But he was.
Allah was in the tree, and he spoke from the tree, and he said to him, I am Allah. Who spoke? You said to me, oh, the tree spoke. So the tree said, I am Allah.
Wait a minute.
I'm waiting.
I did not hear. My mom was calling me, so.
Oh, your mom. Okay, say hi to your mom. Now let me ask you. Did you just say that Allah spoke through the tree? So, and the tree says, "I am Allah." So now Moses is standing in front of the tree, and the tree speaking to him, saying to him, "I am Allah." What does that mean? That means Allah is a tree.
Okay. So if you say I'm Christian, please. From your mic. So does it mean your mic is saying I'm Christian, please, or?
Yeah, but you see, you are being a silly now, because at that time there is no technology. Now we understand that this is possible, that to speak with you the phone. So you are saying to me that Allah can speak. Okay, so you are saying to me. Okay, so now if I hear. Okay, hold on. Is it possible for you as a Muslim? Okay, is it possible for you as a Muslim to hear the voice of Allah from the toilet seat, and Allah use the toilet seat as a phone? Is that possible? Is that okay? Why no? A second ago you said it's possible. You see the hypocrisy? A second ago you said it is a phone. He spoke from the tree, but he was not in the tree. Now I ask you, if it's a toilet seat, is it possible? You said no. So you are being hypocrite, because if it's possible there, it's possible there too.
It's possible, but it won't happen.
Why it won't happen?
Because a king can clean the toilet of a slave, but he...
So are you saying to me that if the voice of Allah go inside the toilet, Allah's voice will be dirty?
I'm not saying. I'm saying it won't happen.
The tree is the same. The tree, there's birds, they stand on it, they do poo-poo on it, they do pee on it. I mean, it's a tree. There's worms, there's etc. So you are being hypocrite again. You are being hypocrite again. If the tree is holy, and then that's mean the existence of God doesn't matter where, the place will be holy. Wherever God goes, holy will come, holiness will come. So now you are being hypocrite, and this is showing us the stupidity of the cult of Islam. Now, I'm asking you, you are the one who called me to ask me a question. You said that is the flesh of Jesus is part of the Trinity, which is a very stupid question, because what the flesh? We don't measure Jesus by kilogram. As if you're saying to me, is if we take 1 kilogram of Jesus' flesh, is that the Trinity? That's stupid a question, my friend. For God, he can come to us as he wish. As an example, we will see that God the Father, he came and he spoke to him, the Holy Spirit, spoke through a bird and say, this is my only begotten son, which I sent to the world. So are you going to say to me the bird now is part of the Trinity? That's a stupid of you to say. So Muslims, they play games, and they, when they play games, they look like a bunch of fool. So God, he appear, when God, he appear in a way he want. So here we go. I gave an example from the Quran. Allah, he appeared to Moses as a fire, you idiot, not even as a tree, because you do not know your book. You are playing the game all this time, saying, yes, because you're an idiot, because, okay, hold on. Allah was in the tree or was in the fire? You don't know. Because you Muslims are confused. Okay. Let me rephrase the question for you. Allah was in the fire. Allah was in the fire or in the tree?
Are you inside your mobile now or inside your mind?
I am asking you: is Allah inside the fire or is inside the tree?
He was not there. He was not there.
Who? What is the proof? He was not there.
What?
What is the proof? Okay, you are saying to me he was not there. So who was there?
What is the proof that he was there? What is the proof?
Okay, let us see what is the proof. Guys, when the Muslims, when the Muslims talk, always they make me laugh for a very simple reason. They do not know their book. And they call you, supposedly they school you to teach you that you are wrong. This is what the Quran says. That blessed is the one who is in the fire and the one who is around it. You said he is not in the fire. Everybody heard you.
Yeah.
But the Quran chapter 27 verse 8, it says, but when he came to the fire, a voice was heard from the blessed tree, in the fire.
Yeah.
Blessed are those in the fire. Here you notice something, it says,
yeah, I see.
Okay, it says those. How many Allah you have in the fire? You are the one who says Allah is talking, correct?
Let me see the verse. Wait.
Okay, read the verse.
So, can it not mean that blessed are those who are getting the heat from the fire?
Getting what? The heat? What heat?
Heat, yeah.
What heat? Heat?
Hot heat.
What?
Yeah.
What? What heat? It says, bless those who they are in the fire. Who is in the fire?
People who are getting the hotness of the fire.
My friend, they are in the fire, not around the fire, in. Do you know what in mean? Not the one around it. In, it says, bless those who they are in the fire and the one who is around the fire. So who is the one is in the fire?
Voice of Allah.
So the voice of Allah is in the fire. And where is the fire?
An element.
In the bush, in the tree. Correct?
No. What I meant? Said it's an element.
What?
It's an element.
Element? So Allah is element?
No, I'm saying, you ask what's a fire.
Okay, who is in the fire? You said Allah's voice in the fire, correct?
Yeah.
Okay, a second ago you said to me, when Allah spoke from the tree, is like a cell phone. So now we notice that Allah have two cell phone. He have the fire and he have the tree. Which one was using? Who spoke, the tree or the fire?
No. You are talking, so your voice is coming through the phone, right? Your voice is inside the phone.
Okay.
In a way.
Mm.
So, does it mean you are inside the phone?
Well, my voice is there, right? Is the voice of Allah is part of the flesh of Allah? Allah's voice is not part of Allah. Guys, did you hear this? Did you hear this guy? Did you hear this guy? Allah's voice is not part of Allah. So what does that mean?
Nah, you ask flesh of Allah. You ask something like
okay,
that.
Okay, so the voice of Allah is what?
It's a voice of Allah is an attribute of Allah.
A voice is an attribute? What does that mean? I never heard of this, no. That the voice is attribute. How come? How that?
His speech.
His what?
ability to speak is an attribute of Allah.
Okay, I'm not asking you about his ability to speak or not. I'm asking you the voice itself. Is it part of Allah or it's not?
That's a philosophical question. I don't know.
You don't know. That's a good answer, by the way. You do not know. This is the only way a Muslim can escape the embarrassment. So you Muslims, you have religion. All of it is based on I don't know. And then you claim to be a person who is going to teach me and correct me. So let us go back to zero. Mr. I don't know. Mr. I don't know. Okay. So now let us go back to zero. Mr. I don't know. Mr. I don't know. Mr. I don't know. So the voice of Jesus, which came from inside the flesh of Jesus, is that Jesus or not for you?
It's not Jesus for me.
So the voice of Jesus speaking from inside the flesh of Jesus is not Jesus, according to you?
Yeah.
So who was talking?
I mean, the speech was not Jesus. It was coming from...
No, the voice. Forget about the speech. Forget about what he said. The voice, which is the voice of Jesus, is that Jesus? In the Bible, it says in the beginning it was... Hold on. Okay, let us make it simple for you. Mr. Dawa. The word of Allah, is it part of Allah or not?
Word of Allah? What do you mean? Can you explain it?
I mean, how come you don't know what the word of Allah? Allah, he have words. Okay, is the word of Allah, is Allah or it's not Allah?
It's not Allah, but...
Is the word of Allah, is it created or not created?
Word of Allah? It's not created.
Thank you very much. Guys, the word of Allah is not Allah. Be my witness. He said that, not me. And the word of Allah isn't the creator. So now we have two divine. We have Allah, not the created. We have the word, not the created. And Allah did not create the word. So who is the one who created the word? Nobody. So Allah. So you Muslims. No, stop saying attribute, you crazy person. Because attribute, when you say attribute, that means you are describing God, right? So the word of Allah, you just said it's not part of Allah. It is not Allah. You just said that. So don't stop playing games. The word of Allah, not the created.
Islam of Yahweh.
Okay, listen, don't change the topic. So the word of Allah not the created. So what is the word of Allah if it's not the created? If it's not coming from Allah, Allah did not create the word of Allah. Where Allah he got the word from?
He got it from the beginning.
He got it from
he
where?
Got it from the beginning.
Guys, he got it from the beginning. From
Do
where?
You know that?
Guys, listen. He got it from the beginning. What does that mean? Where Allah, as long he is not the one who created the word, that means this is not his word. Listen. If this word is not from Allah, is it from Allah or not from Allah?
It's from him.
Okay, if it's from him, so how come is it created by him?
Your lag is with you. So did you create it or...
You see, when I speak, I am now giving you my word. So when I move my tongue, I make a sound, and that sound resembles a word. So it's coming from me. So, but you just say that the word of Allah is not created by Allah.
Yeah.
Okay, so it's not from him.
Yeah.
Okay, thank you, guys. He just said, yeah, wonderful. So the word of Allah is not from Allah. So the word of Allah from where?
It's like lawyer. No, it's like lawyer asking people and say yes.
What lawyer? You say the word of Allah is not from Allah anymore. So where is the word of Allah coming from? So the Quran is not from Allah because it's not created by Allah.
It's from Allah.
My friend, hold on.
He did not create.
Just to show you how confused this religion. This is my book. We are giving it for free for the Indonesian people. Deception of Allah for free in their language. Okay.
I'm not saying
who is the who,
I'm saying
okay, my words, my words is in that book. Who is the author of the words? Christian Prince. If I ask you, who is the author of the Quran? You cannot say Allah because you just say the word of Allah is not created by Allah.
But it's from him.
Okay, how it can be from him but not created by him?
Because it exists with him and it exists in his attribute.
My friend, the word of Allah is an attribute now?
not word of Allah, but it exists in his attribute, right?
No, it's not right. Because no, simply attribute is a stupid statement. You keep saying attribute, but obviously you do not know what attribute. As an example, your prophet, your God Allah, one of his names is the believer. He believe in what? He worships somebody? Al-Mu'min. How Allah can be a believer? Believe in what? So you have many stupid attributes in your religion, which is, doesn't make sense. Secondly, when you say the word of Allah is attribute, you are making the word of Allah part of the description when the word is not. You see, when we say to you, is the Quran created? You say no. When you say attribute, Allah, he told you about himself. And then from those things, you learn that Allah have attribute and all of them, they are stupid. But the Quran is a different story. The word of Allah, you just said it exists from the beginning. Beginning of what?
Yeah.
That's mean Allah and the Quran, they will exist independently from each other. And that's mean you Muslims, you have two divine, both of them not created, Allah not created, Quran not created. In Christianity, no. In Christianity, in the book of John, it says in the beginning it was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word is the God. So the word of God in Christianity, hold on. You see, here we see the stupidity of Islam, because the word of God in Christianity is God. So there's no confusion. God is one. You Muslim, you claim that your God is one. No, hold on. You claim that your God
of God be equal to God who has more unlimited attributes. It's nonsense.
Who care about unlimited or not unlimited? Don't change the topic. The word of God in the Islam is not a created. The word of God in Islam is not a create. The word of God is not a created. Okay, hold on. Okay, is Jesus created by Allah?
What?
Is Jesus created by Allah?
Yeah.
Okay, but you just said the word of Allah is not a created.
Yeah.
But Jesus is the word of Allah according to the Quran.
It's word from Allah. That's what it says.
Thank you. Allah, but you, okay, isn't it the Quran a word from Allah?
What?
Isn't it the Quran a word from Allah?
I didn't understand.
No, you understand very well, but you're not play dumb now. I'm saying, isn't the Quran is a word from Allah? Isn't the Quran? Isn't it the Quran itself is a word from Allah? You said that already. You said yes.
Yes.
Okay, but so the Quran is the word of Allah and it's not a created. Jesus is the word from Allah and it's not a created then.
Why?
And it exists with him from the beginning. You are the one who said that. We asked you when the Quran was exist. You said it exists from the beginning.
Okay.
Who created the Quran? You said nobody. Okay. And you said the word of Allah, not a created. Okay, so Jesus is the word of Allah and not a created.
I said it, not you. So let me explain. Okay. Can you hear me?
I hear you.
Okay. So what attribute of Allah that exists with him and the word Allah created, both are from him, right?
My friend, where is the word attribute coming? You know, you keep playing games.
Don't use the logic that
no, I am asking you. You said the word of Allah. The word of Allah.
This terrible diagram.
The word of Allah, is it created or not? Let's go back to zero. Is the word of Allah created? Yes or no?
No.
Okay, Jesus is the word of Allah. Is he created, yes or no?
He is word from Allah, not word of Allah.
Well, if he is the word from Allah, that means he's the word of Allah. Are you crazy or what? It says he is the word from Allah. Thank you, guys. He is the word. He is. You just said he is the word from Allah. Okay, the Quran is a word from Allah too.
Yeah.
Okay, is the Quran created? You said no.
It's the word of Allah.
The word of Allah.
It's also word of Allah, right?
What? Say again.
It's Quran is a word from Allah, but also word of Allah, right?
Okay. And?
But Jesus is not word of Allah. It's word from Allah.
Ah, so he's a word from Allah, but he's not the word of Allah. That's stupid. That's the most stupid thing is. So when you say he is the word of Allah, but is not the word of Allah, that is the most stupid statement ever I heard. When you say this car is a car from Allah, and you say this is not a car from Allah. How you that? You just said he is a word from Allah. Okay, are you saying to me that this word is not Allah word? He borrowed it from somebody, but he sent it to us from him?
Now he created it, then sent it. So it's what
But you are the one who told me how, where the word created is. You see, he is a word from Allah, and you are the one who confirmed.
I can give you the verse.
Oh, hold on. You are the one who confirmed that the word of Allah that created.
I said what from Allah is created.
No problem.
Jesus, what from Allah.
Okay, but the word of Allah is not created.
Yeah.
Okay, so how he is a word from Allah, but he is a created, and the word of Allah is not created.
What from Allah is not.
Okay, Abdul,
Allah.
Abdul. Abdul.
Okay,
let me. I will make it simple for you. I will make it simple for you.
I will make it simple
no,
for
no,
you.
No, no, no. You are me, obviously you are very you are very you are very slow. Okay, my friend. Okay, I want you to look at the screen. I want you to look at the screen. I'm going to make a drawing.
And I cannot look at it.
You cannot look at it. Why you cannot? A second ago, you said to me, you need to look at the screen.
I can see your screen. I can see. I'm on Skype now.
Okay, all right. So here we go. He is a word from Allah. From Allah. Okay, that word is confirmed to be from Allah. Do you agree? Do you agree?
Can you say it again?
Do you agree that the word is from Allah?
Yeah.
Okay. Where Allah he get this word from?
Yeah. He created it.
He created it. Okay. So word of Allah, conclusion, word of Allah is a creator.
Word of Allah, not word of Allah. I said word from Allah.
No problem. Doesn't matter. A word from Allah is a word of Allah. What's wrong with you?
No. If you give me a car, so
okay. Hold on, hold on, guys. So okay. So when Allah he created Jesus, what he used?
What?
When Allah he created Jesus, what he used?
What he used? What do you mean?
I don't know. You tell me. What? How he created Jesus?
He just said be, and it Jesus became.
But this is not what the Quran says. The Quran says that Allah he sent his spirit, and then he blew into her Maryam vagina, and then she had a child. So okay, okay, I will say okay, I will go with you just for the sake of comedy. So Allah he said be what?
So you are doing comedy here. Right?
Okay, he said what? Be Jesus. Okay, did Allah say be Jesus?
No.
What he said?
Be.
Okay, so Allah, he said be. Is the word be created? Is the word be created?
No.
Okay, not created.
But Jesus is not the be. He was created for the be. That's why Jesus was created, but he's not the be.
Well, okay, my friend. You see, this one of the stupidity we see always from Muslims when they try to convince us something is what they say. You just say that Allah, he said to Jesus, be, and he was.
You
just said Allah, he said, be to Jesus, and he was. But the Quran say a different story, that Allah, he sent his spirit, and his spirit blew into, and actually the Quran says, وَنَفَخْنَا فِي فَرْجِهَا نَفَخْنَا فِي فَرْجِهَا Allah, he blew into her vagina. So where is the word be there in the story?
You're cutting off, dude.
You hear me very well. Allah, he blew in her vagina. He did not say be. Where is the word be?
Can you say it again?
Allah, he blew in Mary's vagina. Correct?
What? Can you repeat?
Allah, he blew in Mary.
I did not
hear. Filthy language in the Quran. Allah, وَالَّتِي أَحْسَنَتْ فَرْجَهَا فَنَفَخْنَا فِيهَا مِنْ رُوحِنَا So this is how Allah supposedly he made Mary carry a son. He did not say be. I hear you. He's trying to get out.
Yeah.
Okay.
What did you ask?
I'm saying the Quran says that when Allah he wanted Mary to have a son, when Allah he wanted to have Mary to have a son, he did not say be, as you see. The Muslim even they write.
Can you hear me? Wait.
You hear me very well. There's no way. And look at this false translation, guys. He blew in her shirt. The word farjaha is her shirt. It's a vagina. It says the one who preserved her shirt. Just to show you how stupid this translation. It says here, and remember the one who guarded her chastity. But there is no chastity here. The word is farjaha. So now the word farjaha, which is now coming as a chastity, became a shirt. So why Allah He chose Mary? Because she did not make her shirt dirty. She preserved her shirt. I mean, do you see the stupidity of the translation? How easy to expose? The same word is existed twice in the Quran. وَالَّتِي أَحْسَنَتْ فَرْجَهَا. فَرْجَهَا. So how come فَرْجَهَا here became a shirt? If you go to the other verse, you will see the same. Chapter 66, verse number 12. The word farjaha, they translate as a chastity. The fact it is not chastity, it's a farjaha, it's a vagina. And then we breathe into her shirt? Abdul. Okay, let's try to call him one more time. Because he's badly. Yeah, we cannot reach him. Maybe he's offline now. So you see, guys, the stupidity. They come with the questions very silly. Is the flesh of Jesus is part of the Trinity? What is that? I mean, this is stupid, my friend. God, He come to us in any way He wish. And God is still is the same. God, He appear as a bird, but doesn't mean that He is a bird. God appear as a man. He come as He wish. For God is almighty. He can do as He wish. If God cannot come to us as He wish, He cannot be God too. God can appear as an angel if He want. God can appear as a bird. God can come to us as a man. Jesus said clearly that before Abraham I am. Okay, how He was before Abraham? And the Jews, they said to Him, we are not even 50 years old. How you can be before Abraham? Abraham is dead. And he was exist long time ago. So the existence of Jesus have nothing to do with the flesh. And here you see the stupidity of those copy-paste people. None of them understand what he's talking about. They are copy-paste nation. In the beginning it was the Word. And look how confusing this cult is. The Muslims now, they have a belief that the Quran is not created. So now we have Allah and the Quran not created. So we have two gods. And this is why the deception of Allah is a perfect description for what the Quran is saying to us. It's a deception. Allah is the only God, but the Quran is created by Allah. I thought everything created by Allah. Do you notice, guys? If you ask any Muslim, is everything created by Allah? They say yes, all of them. Why? Because they don't know. They give you false answers. The answer, no, not everything created by Allah according to Islam. The Quran is not. Actually, there's a guy who claimed that the Quran created by Allah. The caliphate, he chopped his head in the mosque like a sheep for saying that. He told them, today we used to slaughter a sheep, but today we will slaughter this guy. Who is this guy? The guy who said that the Quran is created. But let him call me this potato Murrah. Call me Murrah. Very cute Murrah. Hey Murrah, call me so we can have fun. I have tens of thousands of names in my Skype. This is why many people, if you send me messages, they think I can read them. I cannot. I cannot open any of those messages. Don't send me messages there. Hey Mumu, call me Mumu. We have now two divine gods in Islam, Allah and the Quran. Allah that created, Quran that created. How that can be? When you say the Quran that created, that's mean Allah have nothing to do with it. If it's not created by Allah, that's mean Allah have zero doing with the Quran. So what Allah was doing was reading something not His own. So when they come with this stupid belief, they destroy, or let us say, I mean, destroy what? There's nothing to destroy. Islam is destroyed already. If you are Indonesian and you are looking for to read my book for free, we have a link down in the video. Actually, I will make a short video about this book so we can, so people they can know about it and they can download the link. He is not calling no more. He is sorry for calling me. I understand the situation. Your situation, brother, is very hard. Let us call the other guy. But we have another guy here trying to call. Let us see. Is there, please call only if you are a Muslim. Only if you are a Muslim. Answer, answer. He is not. Okay, we have a Muslim. I don't know what happened to my Skype. I see, I hear ring, but I don't see the caller. Hold on. I think I need to stop. The Skype stuck. I'll close the app and open it again. Give me a second. I hear a ring, but I don't see anyone is calling. Okay. This guy, I think he was calling. Hello?
Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum assalam.
Yeah, brother, I'm Sanwar. My name is Sanwar.
Okay.
I am from Bangladesh. I'm a Muslim. So, how are you?
I'm very fine. But I'm really surprised, my friend, that you said to me, Assalamu alaikum. I thought, according to Islam, you should not say to me, Assalamu alaikum, as you know.
Okay. So, is it mentioned in the Quran? Is there any parts of the glorious Quran that I should not say Assalamu alaikum to the non-Muslims?
Oh, well, this in the Hadith. Aren't you a Muslim Sunni?
There is a huge dispute of this issue because some of the scholars, they said that it's allowed, and the Hadith is regarding to a particular group of people who replied Assalamu alaikum, who replied Assalamu alaikum means death be upon you. So Jews and Christians.
But your prophet, he did not say to some people, he said in the Hadith, don't initiate salam to the Christians and the Jews, all of them. He did not say some.
No, this is how the scholars, they have explained.
Yeah, you see, your scholars. Okay, my friend. Okay, my friend. If I say something to you, shouldn't you say to me, give me the proof?
Yeah, hello.
Okay, if I say something to you, shouldn't you say to me, give me the proof of what you are saying? So when the scholars, they say something, they have to show the proof. They fail. So they are fabricating things, you know. Now, let us say, because some, he said, some on you, as you claim. But Muhammad, he did not say as a response, don't initiate to those who say that to you, salam. He said, don't initiate salam to anyone who's a Christian or a Jew, correct? Okay, so the explanation of the scars is false. Now, let us go to the more serious topic.
First of all,
okay, you call me for what reason, my friend? What do you want to say to me? Hello?
Hello?
Yeah, what do you want to say to me? You call me for what reason exactly? What do you want to say? We have almost 1,300 people listening.
I am interested in discussing, so I want to learn something new.
All right.
Because I have discussed so many, talked to so many Christians and of my friends. There are so many Christians of my friends. So I am a student.
You said you have a friend?
I'm a student and 20 years old. I'm a young boy. So I'm interested in discussing, learning something.
You just say.
So one of my friends, he gave me your number, brother. So I can ask you regarding to Islam, any question that how Islam is false or how Quran is false. So this is what my friend said to me. So that is why I called you to teach me something about how Quran is false or how Islam is false.
Okay, let us do this. Give me something you think Islam make it truthful to you, and I will destroy it. Anything.
Brother, I cannot hear clearly. One second. Let me take my earphone.
Okay.
Yeah, thank you so much. So now I can hear.
Yeah. Give me something you think it's powerful to prove Islam to be from God, and I will destroy it. As long as this is your request, to show you Islam is false. Give me the most powerful thing for you, make you believe that Muhammad is a prophet. Right.
Okay, so first of all, I want to say that I want to ask a question. So we Muslims, we believe that Islam is not a new religion. We believe that Islam means submission to the will of God. So Islam, all the Muslims, all the prophets, they were Muslims. They submitted to the will of God, and their religion was Islam. So Islam is not a new religion. It is not a this is what we believe. So what's your opinion about this?
First of all, the Islam does not mean submission. Islam means surrender. If you go to chapter 48 in the Quran, chapter verse number as an example 16, and chapter 49 verse number 14, you will see the Quran saying clearly that they say we are Muslims. What is the word there? Is surrender. So Islam does not mean submission. This is a false, and I heard the Christians saying that, but I understand the Christians, they are learning from Muslim what they say. So they say, well, Islam means submission. The fact nowhere the Quran says Islam means submission, it's mean to surrender. So say to the Muslim, to the Arab, say to the Bedouin, the Arab, if you don't convert to Islam, we are going to come and kill you unless you surrender. All right? So if Islam is a good religion from God, why Muhammad making a threat to the Arabs saying, if you don't convert to Islam, you are going to fight people who are of mighty war, and we are going to force you to surrender anyway. So Islam does not mean surrender. And then I will say to you, if those people, they surrender, and now they say, we surrender, we are Muslims. So are they Muslims really?
Okay, I want to share one verse regarding this issue. Chapter 2, Surah Al-Baqarah, chapter 2, verse number 208. It is mentioned that, Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu dkhulu fi silmi kaffa. Okay, amanu dkhulu fi silmi kaffa. So the word Islam, the root word of Islam is silm. Okay, silm means submission. And it also comes from the word salam, means peace. Okay. So
can I answer you?
Acquiring peace by submitting to the will of God.
Okay,
this is what Islam means. Let me explain. Please explain to me chapter 2, verse number 208.
Hold on.
Allah is telling.
Yeah, I will explain.
My friend,
give me a chance to answer you. You just said something very funny and destroy Islam. You yourself, not me. Because you just said, oh, you believe, enter into Islam. They are believers already. I mean, this is the most stupid statement.
My friend. Can you explain the verse?
I'm explaining the verse you gave me. It says, all who you believe, enter into Islam. They are believers. So how they can enter into Islam?
Okay. Yeah, they are. This verse is talking about the believers, of course.
No. It says enter. He's asking them to enter into Islam. But it says, oh, who you believe.
Yeah.
So, did they believe or they don't believe? If they believe, it's already they are Muslim. So, the phrase is stupid. Doesn't make sense. It's like saying, oh, Christians believe in Jesus. You know, they are Christians. They believe in Jesus. That's why we call them Christians. So, the verse you gave me, showing me that the one who wrote the Quran is a drunk and he is taking hashish. Secondly, if Islam means peace, as you say, this is a psalm. You see the Muslim translated as Islam. Islam in Arabic, it means to surrender, which means the opposite of salam, because salam is coming from the word shalom or shlama in the Arabic. Convert to Islam, we will kill you unless you surrender. And then if I ask you, my friend, if I ask you, if you convert to Islam, those people who converted to Islam in this verse number chapter 24 48 verse number 16, if they converted to Islam, by forcing them to convert to Islam, are they considered Muslims?
Brother, this is another topic. So
no, no, it's not another topic. No, 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 this is not another topic. My friend, I'm asking you a very simple question. Don't skip, please. Don't skip. You see, I'm speaking to you as an adult. Let us speak as adult.
Give me 1 minute.
Okay, no, no, don't change the topic. Don't change the topic. I'm asking you. I want the answer. I want the answer. I want the answer. Those who you force them, this verse is speaking about forcing those who you force them to convert to Islam according to the verse. Are they Muslims? If they say Shahada.
Okay, you know that forcing is absolutely prohibited in the Quran chapter 2, verse number 255, like Rahabiddin.
Hmm.
There is no compulsion in religion. Okay, hmm. we shall
no, 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 first of all, no, first of all, first of all. First of all.
So,
no, 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 don't escape, don't escape. You can't escape with me. You know you are calling Christian prince, you can't escape. The verse you call me is about that the Christians and the Jews, they cannot force their children not to convert to Islam, not the opposite. Because your prophet says, fight those who don't believe in Allah. So how there is no compulsion in religion, and then...
You are quoting a verse, brother, you are quoting a verse, chapter 9, verse number 31. I shall explain this verse, I shall explain. I know the answer of this question, no problem. But my point was that you have said that the Allah is telling in this verse the believers to enter into Islam. So my point is, Iman and Muslim, there is a huge difference between the word Iman and is a Muslim, okay?
Hmm.
There is a huge difference because walam yudkhilul iman fi qulubihim, the iman has not entered in their heart.
Hmm.
Okay, so they are Muslim, they say we are Muslim, but the iman has not entered. So there is a difference between iman and Muslim, okay?
Hmm.
So in this verse, chapter 2, verse number 228, it is mentioned, ya ayyuhal ladina amanu dkhulu fi silmi kaffa, amanu dkhulu, enter fi silm. Silm means fully submission, in full submission, in the state of.
And what is the penalty? So what is the penalty? What is the penalty? What if those people do not enter into Islam? What will happen?
This is another question. This is another topic.
You see, you are escaping because now you. But this is showing me. This is showing me you are not calling really to discuss. You are calling to escape issues. So you are the one who says Islam means peace and means submission. And the second I say to you, if those people they don't want to enter Islam, what will happen to them? You don't want to answer that because the answer is going to be killing them. So Islam is not peace, as you claim. Your prophet, did your prophet say, did your prophet say, Aslim Taslam? Did he say Aslim Taslam? What Aslim Taslam mean? Why Quran only? Are you a Quran only person? Are you a Quran only person? Or you take Hadith too?
Yeah, we should discuss about Hadith also.
No problem. So you're a prophet, he said, okay, you're a prophet says, convert to Islam, you will be safe. What does that mean?
What?
Convert to Islam, you're a prophet, he sent a message to the Hercules, to Hercules, the king of the Romans, saying to him, convert to Islam, you will be safe. Safe from what?
Yeah, convert to Islam, you will be saved from the hellfire. It may be this is the hadith referring to. I don't
well, that's a
that
that's a good lie, my friend. That's a good lie because Muhammad he ordered you to do jihad against the Christian who don't believe in Allah. So embrace Islam, you will be saved. You are talking to who? Talking to a king. He sent a threat to him, and then we will find the answer for your lie. Sorry to say the word lie because you are lying now. Isn't it your prophet? He says, "I be commanded to kill all mankind until they convert to Islam."
This is not what the prophet said. Okay, let me share what the prophet said.
No, 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 no. Hold on. You are accusing me. Hold on. No, no. This is what the prophet said. This is what the prophet said. Prove me a liar. Here we go. You just said this is not what the prophet said. So you're saying I'm lying. Here we go. You're a prophet saying, "Umirtu an uqatil an-nasa jami'an." I've been ordered to commanded to kill all mankind unless they say I am a prophet and Allah is God. Why you are lying,
okay,
my friend?
Let me explain this. No, let me explain this hadith. The Prophet said, I have been commanded to fight against, to fight or to strive against those who don't believe. Okay, what is meant by it? To fight and to strive, not by killing people. It is intellectual fight. It is a logical, reasonable fight. For example, let me give an example. For example, so in another hadith, it has been explained. Okay, so Sahih Bukhari hadith number 6871. It is mentioned that narrated Anas ibn Malik, the Prophet said that the biggest sin, the great sin, the greatest sin is to join others as partners in worship with Allah, to murder a human being. Second number is to murder any human being. Okay, third number is to be undutiful to one's parent. And fourth number is to make a false statement. This is a Sahih al-Bukhari hadith number 6871. So in this hadith, the Prophet is telling that to murder any human being means to kill any innocent people is absolutely prohibited. Okay, let me give one verse of the Quran, chapter 25, verse number 68. Allah is telling that وَالَّذِينَ لَا يَدْعُونَ مَعَ اللَّهِ إِلَٰهًا آخَرَ وَلَا يَقْتُلُونَ النَّفْسَ الَّتِي حَرَّمَ اللَّهُ. Okay, they don't kill any soul except cause. What is the cause? أَنَّ النَّفْسَ بِالنَّفْسِ وَالْعَيْنَ بِالْعَيْنِ. This is the cause. This is the ransom for killing. قِصَاص. This is called قِصَاص. وَلَكُمْ فِي الْقِصَاصِ حَيَاةٌ يَا أُولِي الْأَلْبَابِ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَعْقِلُونَ. So the Prophet is telling that kill any innocent people is absolutely prohibited, and if anyone kill any innocent people, he killed as to the whole of humanity. Chapter 5, verse number 32. Okay.
Are you done?
So, So now, give me a half minute, okay? Half minute. Let me finish. So, in the Quran, the verse regarding to war, this is defensive war. This is not offensive war. For example, chapter 2.
Okay, you are reading for me an article. Okay, my friend, you are reading an article. This is what you do. You open an article, you start reading. Let me show everybody in 2 seconds that you are lying, my friend. With my respect to you, you are a liar. The hadith in front of me, it says, Allah Messenger said, I have been ordered to fight the people till they say, none has the right to be worshipped but Allah. And if they do so, pray like us, face the Qibla, slaughter as we slaughter, then their blood and their property will be suckered from us. So look at the big fat lie you just did to yourself. Everybody will be laughing at you later in the internet for what you just said. You said to us that the Prophet been ordered not to do the following, not to kill innocent people. Your Prophet, he did kill millions of people. Your Prophet is the biggest slaughter machine ever. What is the guilt of those innocent people? According to you, you said you cannot kill. So shut up, don't talk. Let me, I give you the time to talk, let me talk. Okay, listen. So you said innocent people in Islam, innocent is only those who believe in Allah and the hate in front of you. So those who don't believe in Allah, they are guilty. Why? Because they did not believe in Allah, so they are being to be killed. And when your prophet says, I've been commanded to fight all, he's not fighting those who are fighting him. He's fighting those who don't worship Allah. This is why if we go to chapter 9, verse number 29, it says, fight those who don't believe in Allah. Those who what? Don't believe in Allah. From who? From the Christians and the Jews. For what is the guilt they did? For not believing in Allah, then you kill them and you slaughter them. And if they want to live, they have to pay you money. Protection money, mafia, gang leader. So fight against those who believe not in Allah. Do you see where it says those who they are fighting you? No. Those are the Christians. They are not fighting him. They never fought him. Actually, they gave him refugee. But Muhammad, as usual, he's a coward. He go there to their house, he eat their food, and then he want to kill them. So fight those who don't believe in Allah, number one. Nor the last day. Okay, so they don't believe in Allah, and the last day, kill them too. Nor forbid what is forbidden by Allah. So if you don't forbid what Allah forbid, then we will kill you too. And then those who acknowledge that not the religion of truth, which is Islam. So you are lying to us saying that innocent person, the Quran says, that if you don't kill innocent people, the fact this verse you quote for me is not even for the Muslims. This is what Allah said to Moses. This is from the command, the Ten Commandment of God he gave to Moses. You should not murder. So you Muslims, you claim something, the Quran proved the opposite. Secondly, let me ask you, if a child, he's a Muslim. He did not commit sin. Can you kill him in Islam? He's a Muslim. Remember, he's a Muslim.
Okay.
Can you kill him in Islam? He's a child. He's a child and he's a Muslim. Can you kill him in Islam?
No, no, no. What's the question? I could not understand. If a child, he lives Islam, is it the question?
No. If a child, he did not do anything yet. Okay. And he's a Muslim. He's a son of a Muslim family and he's a Muslim. Can you kill him? Is that legal to kill a child? He is a Muslim.
No.
No? Are you sure?
Not only Muslim. Yeah, of course.
Okay. So I want you to open the Quran with me and everybody will start laughing at your no. Isn't it your God in the Quran says, hold on. Isn't it your God in the Quran? He said that there is a child who commit no sin and he was slaughtered. Yes or no? By which Allah
verse,
order.
Which verse, brother?
Can you give me like a week to find it?
Yeah, sure, of course.
Chapter 18, verse number 74.
I want to answer.
Chapter 18, verse number 74. I was joking with you. I was joking with you. Chapter 18, verse number 74. Read it.
Chapter 18, verse number 74. Okay.
Yes. Hmm.
Okay, a minute. Yeah, فانطلقوا حتى إذا لقيا غلاما فقتله قال أقتلت نفسا زكية بغير نفس لقد جئت شيئا نكرا. It is talking about Khizr alayhi wasallam. Khizr alayhi wasallam. This is a miracle that he knew the future. And he understood the future, that this child will be, in the future, this child will cause corruption. Okay, and that's why he was informed by Allah. And this is a huge story. Okay, this is a story of Musa, between Musa alayhi wasallam and Khizr alayhi wasallam. Okay, before going to this story, I want to share.
Hold on. Everybody will be laughing at you in a second. Hold on, guys. Did he say that Allah? Hold on. A second ago, you said to me that we should not kill an innocent person. Who is an innocent person? A person who did not commit a crime yet, correct?
Yeah, of course.
Okay, did this guy commit a crime?
No, of course not.
So you are killing him for a crime he did not do. So look. You are the one who said, there's no compulsion. Hold on. You are the one who said there's no compulsion in religion and you don't force things on people and people, they do as they wish. The verse saying that he is an innocent person. And look what you said. You said Allah informed Al-Khadr that this is a person will do in the future. So are we going to kill all the children today who tomorrow they will be bad? Is that the justice of Islam? Before you do bad, we will take you to slaughter machine? In the top of that, you say Allah in for all the...
Hold on. If you give me time, I will give you time.
And Moses is a prophet too, correct?
Yeah, of course.
Okay, so how come Musa's the prophet, he do not know what Khadr the prophet he know? Allah hide that from him?
He hide from Musa alayhi wasalam, but he informed to Khizr alayhi wasalam. What is the reason? Because the reason is Musa alayhi wasalam said that I am the best of Noah. That means I know. One man asked Musa alayhi wasalam that who is the knowledgeable person at the present time. So he said I am. So that's why Allah informed him that there is a person, there is a servant of mine that he knows more than you. So that is why the Musa alayhi wasalam was traveling to find out this person, to know something from him. Okay.
I'm going to go with you. What is the wisdom of this stupidity? That a child, he will be bad in the future. I'm going to kill him now. What is the wisdom of that? Go ahead.
Okay, I shall answer this question. I already said, my dear brother. Let me answer the first point.
No, no, you did not answer. No, no, I'm asking you, what is the wisdom? Yeah. Because you said that he is teaching Moses. Don't change the topic.
You are driving to one.
Don't change the topic. Please, we are adult. Don't change the topic. You said that Moses is learning from Al-Khadr. Yeah. Okay, what now Moses he learned? That if we see a child and we think he will do something bad in the future, we should kill him now. Is that what you are saying?
Yeah, he was in Khizr alayhi wasalam.
Okay, so now what Moses learned from this? What Moses learned from this? Okay, you are saying to me, he is teaching Moses something.
This is just a miracle.
My friend, you are saying to me, he is teaching Moses something. So now Moses, he will go in the street, and if you look at a child, and he don't like how he look like, he will slaughter him because he learned that from Khadr.
No, of course, we don't know the Khadr. We don't know.
Okay.
He was a prophet.
Okay.
Okay. Mm-hmm. We don't know the future. The prophet, Almighty God informed. Hmm. The future to the prophet, not to us. Okay.
Hmm.
So let me clarify this verse. In the second part of this verse,
uh-huh.
It is mentioned that Qala, who said Musa alayhi salam said, "Aqatalta nafsan zakiyatan bighayri nafsin." Musa alayhi salam condemned him. Musa alayhi salam said that you have committed a grave sin. Musa alayhi wa sallam is telling to Khizr alayhi wa sallam that you have committed a grave sin because he is an innocent child, but you have killed him.
Mm.
So what's the reason?
Mm.
So later on, he was informed that this is a miracle. He was informed that this child will make corruption on the land in the future when he will be adult.
Mm.
This is not. We don't.
Okay, I will go with you. What's your name, my friend?
My name is Sanwar Islam. Sanwar, I am from Bangladesh.
Alright. Okay, my friend, I will go with you. Everybody will be laughing again at what you said. You said that this child, he will do in the future corruption. So you in Islam believe that a person, he will be judged and killed before even he do the crime. And that is supposedly the miracle. I want to go with you just to show you the stupidity of your cult. But isn't it your prophet who said that a person who do the deed of hellfire because of Allah's destiny?
Okay, that is a very good question. Let me answer this question. If you give me time, I shall answer this question.
Go ahead.
Inshallah.
Mm. Go ahead.
Yeah. So we know that Allah knows the future, the past, future, and present, everything. He knows the future.
Mm.
So what I am going to happen, I shall do in the future, Allah knows. This is called Qadr. We believe in Qadr. Qadr means predetermined.
Mm.
So before the creation of the heavens and the earth, before the creation of the universe, 50,000 years ago, Allah wrote everything. So why? Because He knows. Okay, but he has given us freedom of choice.
Hmm.
That's why we cannot blame him, because he has given us freedom of choice. But he knows the future. That is why he knows that this child will make corruption. He knows it, because Allah knows the future.
Okay.
That is why Allah informed Khizr alayhi wasallam that this child will make corruption when he will be adult. This is a miracle. This is not general term. This is not general.
All right.
We cannot use this issue for all time. This is
let us stop here. Let us stop here, please. The predestiny, is it the predestiny about Allah knowing what will happen, or he decide to you what will happen?
He knows what will happen in the future.
So he decide. He don't decide.
There is the present. There is the past. There is the future, in the sight of Almighty God.
Okay. When you commit adultery.
Okay. Hold on.
When you commit adultery, is that something Allah forced you to do, or you choose to do adultery?
Adultery. There are four things is written when we are in
this
the
is not the question, my friend. Why Muslims always they pay this game? Are you trying to be like Zakir Naik? I ask you about the East, you answer about the West. I'm asking you a very simple question. If somebody commit adultery, is he choosing to do adultery, or Allah force him to do adultery?
Oh, of course not. Allah,
of course not what?
Is it Allah is forcing me to do adultery? Of course not.
So Allah did not force you to commit adultery. Okay, guys, Allah do not force you to commit adultery. Okay, I want you to read the hadith in front of you. Go ahead. Read the hadith. Read the hadith. Hold on. You see, talk is a cheap. You talk too much. You say nothing. Read the hadith in front of you. You said Allah do not force you to commit adultery. The mic is yours. Read the hadith in front of you.
Yeah.
Go ahead.
Yeah. Okay. Hello.
Read it. Read the hadith. Read the hadith. I showed you hadith on the screen. I want you to read it, please. Go ahead. Read it for us.
Yeah. Please show me the hadith.
Yeah, it's in the screen already.
Yeah. 1 minute. I'm not getting. Okay, please read to me. Please read.
No, my friend, you are getting it. Come on, refresh your page. You will see it. Refresh your page. I'm waiting. Go ahead. I mean, you see it, but you don't want to read it, right? It's embarrassing. It's exposed all the lies you told me.
Yeah, please read to me or give me the...
Read it. It's in front of you. No, I want you to read it. No, I want you to read it. Go ahead.
Yeah, please give me. Or
it's in the screen. Read it.
I'm not getting in the screen, brother. Sorry for that.
Okay, I will read it for you. You insist, number, okay? Sahih Muslim, hadith number. Sahih Muslim, hadith number 2657B.
2657.
Letter B. The Prophet said, the Messenger of Allah said.
Sahih Muslim 2657.
Allah said, read for us. Go ahead. Find it.
Yeah, let me find out one second. Let me find out in Google. I'm searching in Google.
Okay. If you are in the chat in the YouTube, click at the link. They are posting it for you.
Yeah, 2657B, right?
Yes.
Yeah. Thank you. The Book of Destiny. Okay. Verily, Allah has fixed the very portion of adultery which man will indulge in, and which he of necessity must commit. The adultery of the eye is lustful look. The adultery of the tongue is, I have read the hadith,
Okay.
So what is the question?
Does it say that this is a sin you must commit? You must, it's a necessity to commit? And Allah, He wrote that for you?
Okay. So let me explain it. Because there are so many hadith, the Prophet said that don't commit adultery or fornication. It is absolutely forbidden. There are several hadiths. Okay. So what is meant by this hadith? This hadith means that Allah has given us the organ, and He has given us the freedom of choice. So if
it says that in this hadith, guys, in this hadith, it says Allah gave us the freedom of choice. He says Allah has fixed the very portion of adultery for which a man will indulge, and then it's which is in necessity he have to commit. So Allah, He wrote for you how much adultery you will do, and you are saying to me free of a choice. I mean, are you crazy?
Are you telling that there are several hadiths I can show you from Bukhari and Muslim?
I don't care. Your prophet is a crazy man, my friend. Your prophet is a crazy man. This is not a question. Don't tell me there's other hadith. Here we go. Your prophet saying that you must. Okay, let me ask you. To make it simple. No, hold on. When Adam, he commits sin, did Adam, Allah force him to commit sin, or Adam, he choose to commit sin?
another question.
No, this is not, because we are talking about destiny. We are talking about destiny, because we are talking about the destiny of that child who was killed. He's an innocent person. Allah is the one who will make him do bad, and now before he do bad, he is killing him, which is stupid. So I'm asking you now, when Adam commits sin, did Allah force him to commit sin, or Adam had a free choice to do or not?
Adam had picture. That's why Adam said, "Rabbana zalamna anfusana wa illam taghfir lana wa tarhamna lanakunanna min al-khasirin." Our Lord, we have done something wrong.
Okay, so you are accusing your prophet. So you are accusing your prophet to be a liar. Hold on. No. You are accusing your prophet to be a liar. No, you are accusing your prophet to be a liar. Thank you very much. Showing us that the religion of Islam is a religion of contradiction and stupidity, because the Muhammad, he said that Adam and Moses, they have a debate. And Moses says to Adam, because of you, we are of heaven. This is Sahih al-Bukhari. This is Sahih Muslim. You cannot deny them, say they are weak. They are very authentic. And then Adam, he says to him, are you accusing me of doing something which Allah, he wrote for me 40 years before my creation? 40 years before what? Before my creation. And then your prophet, he says, well, and this is how Moses, he lost the argument with Adam. So Allah, he here, the law prophet saying, before Adam was created, Allah decided for him to commit sin. And Adam saying to Moses, are you blaming me for doing this when Allah, he ordained this for me 40 years before he created me? What's your answer for this?
Yeah, that's a very good question. I can answer this question, inshallah. Mm. So the answer is mentioned in the glorious Quran itself. Okay, chapter 2, verse 30, Allah is telling that وَإِذْ قَالَ رَبُّكَ لِلْمَلَائِكَةِ إِنِّي جَاعِلٌ فِي الْأَرْضِ خَلِيفَةً not فِي الْجَنَّةِ خَلِيفَةً. Allah is telling to the, remember when Allah told to the angels that I am going to create vice-gerent to our human beings on the earth, fill earth, not in Jannah. So the question is, why did he allow to stay in Jannah? This is the question. So why I asked that to a Muslim friend of mine, or to an imam also, I asked this question, that Allah said that he is going to create human beings on the earth, not in Jannah. So why was it necessary to say to Adam that dwell in Jannah? Why? Because we know Allah knows the future. And future, everything is planning of Allah. And nothing, because nothing occurs except the knowledge of Allah. So let me explain this. So because when Adam, the question arises that if Adam said that it is Allah who forced me to do so, why did he not say that, oh Allah, you have forced me to do this thing, that is why shall I seek forgiveness? But this is not the question of Adam. This is not what Adam said. Adam said, qala rabbana zalamna anfusana, I have committed sin. So the question is that if Adam, he understood or he knew that Allah has done this, he has forced me to do so, then why did he not say, oh Allah, you have forced me to do so, why shall I seek forgiveness? This is my question.
Okay, are you done? So my friend, do you know how to read? Do you know how to read, or you are illiterate like your prophet? It says here, yet you blame me for a thing which Allah had ordained for me before he created me. So can we blame Adam for his sin, or we cannot? No, we cannot. Why? Because this is not his choice. Because if it is a choice, then we can blame him. But if it is not his choice, then we cannot blame him.
My question was, if it is not the choice of Adam, then why did he seek forgiveness? This is the question. He said,
okay, I will go with you. Guys, why he seek forgiveness? That is a stupid statement to say, because if Moses been schooled by Adam saying to him, you cannot blame me for a thing which Allah has ordained for me, and the one who's saying that is your prophet, that's mean your prophet is an idiot. He says something in the Quran. He said the opposite in the Hadith, because we cannot blame Adam for his sin. No, so why Adam? He need to ask for. Hold on. Why Adam? He need to be forgiven from his sin when he did not choose to do his sin. Because do you see what your prophet says? Yet you blame me for a thing which Allah had ordained for me. So you cannot blame me for something out of my control. Do you agree?
Okay. So, okay. No, I shall explain it all.
Okay. So you cannot blame Adam for what? For disobeying Allah. What is the excuse? How you can blame me for something Allah decided for me before He created me? He decided for me. So the predestiny you are talking about is not about Allah knowledge. You are lying, my friend. It's about Allah fixing a destiny for you, which you should do.
Okay.
Can I
give an example to explain?
No, don't give an example. The hadith in front of you. The hadith in front of you. You see, you are trying to.
This is
what you Muslim you try to avoid. Yeah, you see.
I know the explanation of this hadith.
No, you did not know the explanation. You already gave me false answer. Let me make it simple for you. If a child he die, he commit no sin. He go to heaven or to hell.
I don't know.
What do you mean don't know? What is the logic?
I don't know where shall I go, heaven or hell. I don't know.
No, I'm asking you. The logic. Okay, according to Islam, a person who commits sin, he go to heaven or to hell?
Yeah, if a person commits sin, but he seek forgiveness.
Okay,
letter,
no problem. But this is a child. This is a child. This is a baby. This is a baby. He don't know even how to talk. So
it depends on what kind of sin. It depends on
my friend, this is a baby. This is a baby. A baby. Hold on. You are a copy paste machine, my friend. You are a copy. All look like all those Muslims who come from Bangladesh. They are the same, like Sabir and etc. Listen to me carefully before you open your mouth. I'm saying a baby, a child who don't talk. What sin? He did not commit any sin. Where he will go? To hell or to heaven? Let us say a Muslim. He have a child. He is 5 days old, 1 month old, 1 year old. He die. Where this child will go?
Jannah, then he will go to Jannah.
Thank you very much. Just everybody will see in a second. Okay, guys, did you hear him saying he will go to Jannah? Here you see that Muslims are very confused people because they have a very false prophet. Islam is a joke. Here we go, you're a prophet, saying it clearly, that a child, he might go to hell because Allah, he determined where every soul will be before he created them. So if he commits sin or not, doesn't matter. Here, Muhammad, he went to a funeral and he took with him Aisha. And then when in the way they are coming back, Aisha, she said, oh, this child, he is an innocent child. He commit no sin and he did not even reach the age of sin. So Aisha said, as you said, he will go to heaven. What Muhammad said, he said, Aisha, don't be stupid. He might go in the other place, which means to hell. Read carefully with me. Hadith number, Sahih Muslim, Hadith number 2662, C. Allah, Messenger, and people, they will post it for you in the chat so you can open it from your side. Aisha, she said, who said? Aisha, not me. After a funeral of a child from Al-Ansar, so they are very Muslim. Allah, Messenger, she said to him, there is a happiness for this bird who is a bird from paradise. Of paradise, for it commit no sin, nor has reached the age of sin, when someone can commit sin. He said, Aisha, peradventure, it might be the otherwise, because God created for paradise those who they are fit for it while they were in their father lions. So you commit sin or not, doesn't matter. It's a predestiny. This child did not commit sin, neither reach the age of sin. Muhammad don't agree he will go to heaven guaranteed. Because it might be the otherwise, for Islam is a predestined destiny. So Islam is a fraud, your mic.
Yeah, I got the point. But the answer is, the destiny, if we talk about the destiny, we have to collect all the hadiths, because this is not...
No, don't bother me. All the hadith, they should be consistent, and this is Sahih hadith. You're a prophet saying it clearly. It's about a child. There's no way more to play games. And this is why you don't want to, you want to skip it. You want to jump over it. You can bring all the hadith beside it. The child, he did not commit sin. He did not do any sin. He did not even reach the age of sin. So why it's possible he will go to heaven? And then you said, who care about the other hadith now? Is this hadith accurate or not? It is. Is it authentic? It is. It is sahih? It is. Who said that? Muhammad. How that can be true? A child who commit no sin, yet he will go to hell. Why? Because Allah decided to him before he was created, like Adam, 40 years before he created him, where he will be. So Islam is a stupid cult. It doesn't matter if you commit sin or not. It doesn't matter if you pray or not. You will go to hell if Allah decide to do so.
My dear, Yeah, to be honest, my dear brother, I have got the point. I have to study the hadith, this hadith particularly, okay? Because I have to study this hadith. I shall study this hadith, then later on I shall answer.
What do you mean you need to study? Hold on. I'm not giving you a book to study. It's a few lines. Hold on. You see how this is how you escape the conversation, because now we have a shot in the head, Muhammad proving to be false, and now you are saying to me, I need to study this hadith. Take your time. I'm listening. Go ahead. Study it. Go ahead.
Yeah, of course. I shall study this hadith now. It does not mean, if I don't give the answer
my
now,
friend, no, don't go, don't go. No, you see? No, because answer. Here we go. So the second we show you that Islam is a stupid cult, you said, I will study. Are you saying to me, what my prophet here, he said, is very stupid. I need to study it. Are you saying that?
It's not the case, my dear brother.
So why you are saying I need to study it? Because why you are getting so confused? Hold on. Because when you say to me, I showed you the first one, the second one, you did not say I need to study it. The second I shot you in the head, you say I need to study it. You are trying to run away from it because it's very simple to explain. I mean, there is no need to, there's no doubt about it. A child, he never commits sin. He never even reached the age of sin. Yet he might go.
I said that I shall answer.
Okay, where is the answer? I'm listening. No.
Okay, I shall answer. Okay. I did not say I will never answer.
No. I don't want you to shall answer. I want you to answer now. No. Is a child, does it make sense? I am the one who asked you, as a child, if he did not commit sin, he's a child. He did not even talk. He died. Where he will go? You said to heaven.
My dear brother, I already said that I will answer after studying this.
No, my friend, study it now. We study it together. We have time. I have time. I will spend the whole month. I will spend the whole month of Ramadan, which is very flexible month. Can be in July and August and December and January. Listen, don't change the topic. You are in the dead spot, and this is why you are trying to escape it. Why this child, he might go to hell? You do not need to study much. It's very simple. Why this child, he might go to hell? What is the explanation of your prophet?
Okay, let me explain this. First of all, God knows the future.
This is not the question. What the future, my friend? What the future? This child is dead already. What the future, you idiot? This guy, he have no future. He is dead. He is a baby. Meh. And you are talking about the future. Are you mentally ill? All of you Muslims, copy-paste, God knows the future. Present it. You are trying to intimidate Zakir Naik, and this is why you look like a joker. So you claim that you have knowledge in Islam, but the fact you are a joker, you are trying to escape, but you are like a turtle. Listen, you are like a turtle. My friend, I am not angry. I'm laughing. You are like a turtle. You are like a turtle who claimed to be a deer.
This is not how to discuss.
You are a turtle who claimed to be a deer. I'm asking you. The child have no future. Why you are mentioning to me, Allah know the future? One of us is a stupid here. Either you or me. The child is dead. And you say to me, Allah knew the future. What's wrong with you?
I did not give the full answer.
No, you did. You said to me, Allah know the future. I ask you, why this child will go to heaven? Why this child will go to hell? You said, Allah, we know Allah knew the future. What the future? The guy already dead. He is a child. He's a baby. He never reached the age of sin, never commit sin. So what the future?
I got your point, my dear brother.
Okay.
I did not say I did not understand.
Okay, give me the answer. So why this person okay. Might go to hell? Give me the answer, please. We are adult, me and you. I want to have a clear answer from someone genius like you. Why this child deserve to go to hell? He commit sin, not did not even reach the age of sin. So why it's possible for him to go to hell?
I will answer later. I already
no, not later, not later. Because my friend, why you are saying no? The answer is there. Why you don't read your prophet answer? Are you ashamed of your prophet?
Yes,
Your prophet gave the answer.
My dear brother, listen.
Listen. Actually, did your prophet in the hadith give the answer or not? Why you don't want to accept your prophet answer? Are you saying your prophet is an idiot? His answer is not accepted?
I already said I have not yet studied this hadith.
My friend, what a study. Even this one needs to study. My friend, did Aisha, when Muhammad, he said to her, hold on. So when Aisha, guys, when Muhammad, he said that to Aisha, did Aisha say to him, okay, I need to study this hadith. I mean, how silly what you are saying. So Muhammad said that to Aisha, and this is the final answer. So why you need to study it? He gave her the answer. Because Allah, he decide who go to heaven when or to hell when they are not created yet. They are in their father's backbone, which is funny because sperm is not coming from the backbone, as the Quran said. And here we see the answer, but you are trying to avoid the answer which your prophet he gave, because it's very embarrassing, showing that Muhammad is a fraud. He says something in the morning, he do something else at night. Now I am asking you for the last time, please, do you accept your prophet answer or you reject it?
How many times shall I give the answer? I have to study this.
Okay, hold on.
Okay, hold on.
So you just say, guys, hold on. Guys, hold on. Hold on. Okay, hold on a second. I ask you. No. Look what you did. Look the disaster you did. You just said, listen, I just said to you, do you accept your prophet? He said, no. I said, do you accept your prophet answer? He said, I need to study it. So you are not believing that your prophet said something stupid like this. This is why you are saying, I need to study it. I don't accept it. It's embarrassing. So you are rejecting your prophet answer, and that's a great sign by calling me, you left Islam, because either you accept what your prophet just said and you say, yes, I accept it, or you say, I don't.
Actually, you are forcing me to give the answer because I already said that I am extracting Quran exactly. I have not read all the hadiths about destiny, and you are forcing me to give the answer of this question. I already said I will ask a shaykh or I will study it and I will get that, because I am not expecting hadith. I am expecting Quran. So you are forcing me, my dear brother, to give the answer. This is not the way how to discuss. This is not the way how to discuss. Okay,
my friend, I'm not answering you. I'm forcing adult talk. Either you are a kid who calling me to play games. You are playing now. Look what happened in two seconds. You play like the guy. His name is Sabil. You sound like Sabil, by the way. Okay. Hold on. Okay. Hold on. I'm not forcing you. You are the one who called me. Didn't you? So I'm asking you now, why you want to skip? This is the topic. This is the topic. Why? Okay, why it's complicated, my friend? Why it's complicated?
Okay. Let me tell you. I started the discussion about the Quran, okay? So now, because from the first topic, you are driving to another topic, because the first topic...
No, it's not my... That's not other topic. It's not other topic. Okay, let me ask you. Now I am going to say, hold on.
This is not the way how to discuss.
Okay, let us see how the way it is. Let me ask you. If I say now the Quran is a fraud, is that me who said that, or Allah, he forced me to say that?
This is a stupid question.
Thank you.
Okay.
So, what's the answer? If I say Quran is a fraud, is it?
Okay. Listen to me. Because all human beings has been given freedom of choice.
Okay, so the answer is what? So why you don't give me the answer? Okay, let me repeat the question, Mr. Bangladesh boy. Listen, I'm asking you, if I say...
That is God's perfect.
Okay, hold on. Let me finish. No, don't waste my time. You see, I have many Muslims who are in Islam waiting for me. Don't waste my time. I'm asking you. If I say the Quran is a book of a fraud, is that me who said that, or Allah forced me to say it?
I said that we are given freedom of choice.
This is not a question. I don't care. I want an answer. Don't repeat yourself, please. Don't repeat. I want yes or no. If I say the Quran is a book of the devil, is it me who said that, or Allah forced me to say that?
Okay, let me get the answer from the Quran itself. I'll get the answer.
I want the answer, yes or no, first. Did I say that, or Allah forced me to say? No, I want. Okay, you can give me. You can give me scriptures as much as you want. That's another question. The question is, if I say the Quran is the book of the devil, if I say either you say yes, it is Allah forced you, or you say no, you made your choice, and then you can give me whatever you want. If I say the Quran is the book of the devil, is it me by my choice who said that, or Allah forced me to say it?
So Allah is forcing you. Is Allah forcing you to say this?
Allah is forcing me, guys. You hear it?
What kind of question, nonsense question is this?
So I don't know. I want an answer. I don't care. It makes sense or not for you. It makes sense for me. So guys, he said doesn't make sense. I'm not okay. So why you don't give me the answer? Why you don't want to give me the answer? Why you don't want to give me the answer, my friend? No. Don't tell me what is my question. This is my question. What's wrong with you?
Let me tell you. In the Quran, chapter
76. This is not the question. Hold on. Shut up. Zakir Naik, potato. Zakir Naik, no. I want an answer. Stop. If I say the Quran is the book, don't force me to hang up on you, please. Don't force me to hang up on you. No, I will not give you 2 minutes. I will give you five hours. I'm with you all the time. I will not hang up on you. But I want an answer. If I say the Quran is the book of the devil, is it me by choice who said that, or Allah forced me? Either you say by choice or Allah forced you. Choose one.
So my question will be, is Allah forcing you right now?
Forcing me, yes. Is Allah forcing me to open my computer, open a chat room, going live in YouTube, insulting Allah, exposing Muhammad? Is he forcing me, or this was a personal choice?
So this is Allah is forcing you now. Is Allah forcing you now?
The question is for you, not to me. You answer.
My question is the answer. To your question. The question
What's
is
wrong with you? What's wrong with you? Guys, I ask him a question. He says, no, that's my question. This is my question for you. Why it is hard to answer? What's wrong with you? When I open my computer, I decide to go live on air, decide to invoke...
Allah has told that inna hadainahu sabila imma shakiro wa imma kafura.
Is that Arabic supposedly? Is that Arabic? You see, since the beginning you start for me speaking Arabic and I laugh. Listen, I want the answer. You see, guys, the cowardness of this skull. You see the cowardness of this skull? They avoid the answer. I'm asking you. Listen, don't force me to hang up on you. Don't force me, talking machine, radio machine. You talk too much, you say nothing. I want an answer. I open my computer. I make a title to expose Islam today. I went live on air. Did I do that by my choice, or it was Allah decide for me to do that?
If you talk 2 minutes, let me give 2 minutes.
No, I want an answer. Either you say Allah forced you, or say no, Allah did not force you. I mean, why it's so hard? Why? You see, guys, when religion, when something simple like this, shut up, coward. You are a coward. You don't dare even to answer a simple question. I'm asking you, can you please, friendly, I'm losing my voice, you idiot. Shame on you. I open my computer to insult Allah, to expose him. Did I do that by choice, or Allah forced me? Why it's so hard? Why this need explanation? Why this need a book? I want you to give me, either you say yes, Allah forced you, or Allah did not force you. Which one?
So the answer is Allah forcing you?
You see the stupid question? Look, I am the one who asked the question. I am the one who asked you the question. Why you don't want to answer it? Is Allah forcing me? I'm asking you. I'm asking you. It's not my... I am the one who asked you the question. So look, guys. Okay, shut up. Get lost. Don't call me again. I lost respect for you. Either you answer or I'm going to hack up on you. This is the last choice. What do you say?
Okay, let me give you 1 minute to say something.
Okay? No, don't say something. I want the answer. You are a coward. You are a coward. And you know, if you know the reason, no, let me call you back. Guys, the reason he is not going to answer because it's very embarrassing. Isn't it clear? I mean, how simple is the question? Let me explain to you. Even this one need explanation. Cult, fraud. They cannot give you an answer. I'm spending the last 20 minutes repeating the same simple question. I open my computer. I say Muhammad is from the devil. Did I choose to do that or Allah force me? He will not answer. He answered me, did Allah force you? Do you see the cowardly religion? The cowardly devil answer? The answer is no answer. For yes, according to Islam, Allah forced me to open my computer and to do poo-poo on Muhammad. This is the answer. And this is why he don't want to answer. So what is this religion make sense? If Allah is forcing me now to go and insult Muhammad, what this religion is about? 20 minutes repeating the same question, I lost my voice. And there's people, they say to me, why you go rude with Muslims? If you sit in my place, you will go crazy, actually. You will have a heart attack. I will call him back, and I will see if he will give you an answer. You will see he will not. He will never give an answer, for this is very embarrassing. So the question again,
yeah, brother.
Don't call me brother, you are a liar, because the Quran says, وَإِنَّمَا الْمُؤْمِنِينَ أُخْوَةً, only the believers are brothers. Take not Christians and Jews as a friend. Chapter 5, verse number 51, you are a liar and you've been exposed for calling me a brother when the Quran forbid you from calling a brother. Actually, the Quran forbid you from taking your own brothers as a brothers. So how you call me brother? But this is a different topic and we will spank you for it later. Now, I open my computer. I am speaking against Islam. Did Allah force me to speak against Islam or it was my choice?
Let me give the first answer. Let me give the first answer because you say that I cannot say brother. Let me give this
No, answer. Don't change the topic now. Don't change the topic. Don't change the topic. Don't change. No, you cannot call me brother. No, you cannot call me brother. Don't change the topic. Don't change the topic. Potato, don't change the topic. Don't change the topic. We can talk about it. Shut up. Shut up. You are a kid. How you respect yourself as an adult? Are you an adult? Why you are escaping the topic? Why you are escaping the topic?
In the Quran.
No, I open my computer. Coward.
Let me get the answer of this question. Because you are claiming something that is against Quran.
First of all, I want you to answer my question and then you can. And then you can show me what you are talking about. Is that okay?
Let me give the answer of the first point you have said. In the Quran chapter 60, verse number 8, it is mentioned that la yanhakumullahu 'anil ladina lam yuqatilukum fid-din wa lam yukhrijukum min diyarikum an tabarruhum wa tuqsitu ilayhim inna Allah yuhibbul mu'allah does not forbid you to deal justly, kindly with those who fought not against you on account of religion, did not drive you out of your homes. Verily Allah loves those who deal with equality and justice.
And this verse is abrogated. This is number one. This verse is abrogated. Secondly, you stupid idiot. That verse is about Aisha receiving. This verse is about Aisha. Muhammad is a person who wanna receive. This verse is abrogated, and the verse in front of you. Shut up, son of Mut'a. Shut up. Quran, chapter 58, verse number 22. It says, you cannot take your brothers as a friend, you liar. You're a brother from your family. This is Quran. Read it, and let everybody laugh at you. Read it, and laugh with me.
No. My dear brother, I shall explain to you. Everything
I am not your brother. Okay, my friend. Hold on. Okay.
Shut up,
you coward. You will never answer any of my questions. Don't call me again. You are a coward. You are a son of Mut'a. You are not a man. You are not a brave. And you change the topic like a monkey. The Quran says, take not Christian and Jews as a friends, so you can take them as a brother, you coward. If you cannot even take me as a friend, how you can take me as a brother? Stupid. The Quran chapter 58, verse number 22, it says you cannot take your own brother and your father, real father, from your blood as a friend. You coward. You liar. The verse you quote for me, it was about the mother of Aisha bringing a gift for her. She asked him, can I receive this gift from someone don't believe? He said yes, and he gave her this verse because it was about a money coming to Muhammad. He's a fraud. But then Muhammad, he said that take not Christians and Jews as a friends. Chapter 3, verse 28, it says the same. And the one who do that, he have no connection with Allah. He is one of them. You are a coward and you are a liar. And you are laughing at yourself. And until now, I'm waiting for my answer. I open my computer. I expose Allah. Is that order from Allah forcing me or my choice? You will not answer that. You know the answer? Because yes, Allah forced me. And that is showing that Islam is nothing but a fraud. Or who you believe, take not Christians and Jews as a friends and protectors or even helpers. And you are calling me brother, you coward liar. So I can be your brother, but I cannot be your friend. I can be your brother, but I am not even your protector. You see the stupidity of those people? They think by talking like a talking machine, they can overcome the truth. You laugh like those women who stand in the corners in the Middle East in the middle of the night in Saudi Arabia, in Mecca. All who you believe, take not the Jews and the Christians as a friends. And if you do, you are one of them. You are what? You are one of them. And if any among you take them as awliya, then surely he is one of them. Do you see it? Guys, have you ever heard of a stupid cult like this before? Do you think if I call him back for the third time, he will answer me about why Allah is forcing me to open my computer and expose him? Do you think he will answer? He will not, right? Why he will not answer? Because it's embarrassing. The answer, yes, Allah, he forced me, according to Islam. Not according to me. According to me, no. I am spanking Allah by my free will. So according to the stupid cult of Islam, Allah forced me to open my computer, laugh at Muhammad, have more than 1,000 or whatever people listening, laughing at Muhammad and his teaching, and then Allah will punish me for forcing me to do this. And this is exactly what happened with Adam. Allah, he forgives Adam the sin which he made him do. And just to make it more funny, Muhammad, he said, if you don't commit sin and ask Allah for forgiveness, Allah will kill you all. And he will replace you with people who commit sin and ask for forgiveness. Look how funny it is. So he forced us to commit sin. And then if we don't ask for forgiveness of sin, he will kill us. Have you ever heard of a garbage cult like this cult? I'm going to call him for the last time and see if he is brave to answer. And by the way, we can go and talk about the friends, the one you are talking about. But I want the answer for this one. You are being a coward. Last time call. Either you answer or go. So are you going to answer, brother, my friend? I'm losing my patience with you. Are you going to answer? Did Allah force me? Did Allah force me? Did Allah? No, don't tell me.
My phone is going.
No, no. The answer is very simple. Okay, either you say yes or no.
My phone is going to off. There is no charge. It is 7%. It will be off.
Okay,
now.
You can
so
call me.
I shall call after charging.
No problem. No problem. Okay. Take care. Bye bye.
After charging.
Okay. Yeah. After. Phone, okay? Yeah. After charging. Yeah. You need to search Google. Yeah. You need to search Google. This is what happened when you talk to a Christian prince. Allah himself need to serve God. I mean, he need to charge the phone and there's no charger. Have you ever heard of a stupid even excuse? He need to charge the phone and there's no charger. So he's going to charge it now, but he don't have a charger. Have you ever heard of somebody, he have a phone, but he don't have a charger? He does. He take it, he put it in the Quran. In the morning, brother, the phone will be wirelessly charged by Allah. Even their excuse is dummy and funny. Silly. Like the other guy in the other day, he said to me, I need to go and bring water, something, drink water, right? He forgot his phone, his microphone open, the stupid. He muted my speaker instead of muting the microphone. He thought by muting my speaker, we cannot hear him no more. And he was talking to the guy next to him to search Google to find the hadith. And then after 10 minutes or 15 minutes, I said to him, okay, so did you drink water? He said, yes, yes. All this time they are talking, he did not move anywhere. So this religion not only does not make sense, it's a stupid to the point. Even a stupid person cannot accept it. This is why I always say, if a fool like Muhammad can fool you, how fool are you? Not how foolish, how fool. Because that will make, because you know, foolish can be an act, a behave, temporarily. Fool, he's a fool. The person who believes in the fool Muhammad, he must be a fool. To the bones. How fool are you? They spend their life studying stupidity. You see, for me, when I was doing my law degree, the sheikhs never answer any questions. The only question they are excited about, if a woman, she asks him, if a guy, he is in love with me, and we want to hold hands, is it okay? Suddenly the sheikh is so excited, he want to talk about it. Suddenly he's so powerful. Suddenly he want to school us about ethnic and, you know, the prophet, he went to his own son and he flirted with the wife when she is married to the husband. Her son from adoption. Suddenly they are about ethic. Any silly question is welcome. Ta-da-dum, 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 ta-da-dum. Assalamu alaikum. Yes, sister. Brother, yesterday I was taking off my clothes in the front of the fish tank and my sister, she told me that the fish are shaking. And she was making it in a very, 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 you know what I'm talking about, in a sound like the guy, he was sweating. The other guy was drinking water. Okay, sister. I think, sister, well, iyazu billah, sister, the fish in your tank, they have a genie. And they are male genie. And they are looking at your beautiful, pure body. Look at this answer. And look at this whore. How many Muslims are getting horny now? The way she was speaking, I mean, it's obviously she is a prostitute. And the sheikh, he was sweating. And then he said to her, you should not, I advise you. She said, when I take off my clothes, I notice, and she, my sister noticed with me, the fish are shaking. The guy, he said, I think, sister, that's what happening, that those fish, they have a genie. And I advise you not to take off your clothes in the front of the fish tank. And then she said, but I have only one room. Look how sad the story. He said, okay, sister, what about you put it like a blanket in the top of the fish tank when you take your clothes off? I mean, do you see how serious the topic is? Millions of Muslims watching a very serious program. A girl, she noticed that fish are masturbating when she take off her clothes. And what is happening? There's a genie inside the fish. Isn't it, this is the most fishy, stupid religion ever? TV station called millions, cost millions. Every day to run it cost a lot of money. People, they're getting paid to answer those questions. They have a salary, they have cars. Another guy he called, he says, me and my fiance, alhamdulillah, we are going to marry next month, but alhamdulillah, I really, we are happy together, but we have a problem. The sheikh, he said, okay, brother, what is the problem? He said, we ate from the same ice cream. And Islam says, if I, we eat, drink from the same milk, she became my sister. Is it true that she became my sister? Look how serious the question. Another guy he called, he says, assalamu alaikum, wa alaikum assalam. Brother, there is no shame in religion. Muslim believe there is no shame, so which you can call and ask about your penis, about your vagina, call whatever you want. So he said, yesterday I was doing hululululu, you know what hululululu, with my wife, and I did suckle her nipples. And then a drop of milk from her nipples swallowed by me. She became my sister now, brother. I mean, the guy is married to the woman. He have 10 kids from her. And now because he have some drop of milk in his mouth, she became his sister. This is Islam, which they don't want you to see. I wish all of you can watch Arabic TV. They are the most hilarious, stupid TV ever. I used to just watch them for fun. You know, like I'm bored, I'm gonna laugh, you know? I just put it, all Christians in the Middle East, they watch Islamic TV just to laugh. Because this is our language, we understand it, we laugh at it. But you cannot go on the street and laugh about it, they will kill you. Once I called at a TV station program, and you know those Muslims, the second you say to him, pray on the Prophet, they start repeating, Salli ala Nabi, Allahumma salli wa sallim. They have to make like, you know, they have to repeat the prayer. I said to them, pray on the Prophet, pray on the Prophet. So I called them, I said, Assalamu alaikum, wa alaikum salam. I said, brother, Salli ala Nabi, Allahumma salli wa sallim. Pray on the Prophet. He repeat after me, Allahumma pray on Muhammad. And then he said, more prayer on the Prophet. And I said, okay, and more Prophet. But guys, 3, 4, 5 minutes, I'm saying the same sentence, more prayer, please, in the Prophet. And they are repeating me like puppies because nobody dare to say, stop being stupid. What is the question? They don't dare. Who dare to say to somebody, he is saying, pray on the Prophet, stop. So I keep repeating, saying, pray on the Prophet. And more prayer on the Prophet. And I have people in my house, they are dying from laughing. I'm trying to stop them from laughing because they will be heard. Then everybody will know we are just laughing at them. They don't dare, and I could not take it no more. I hang up because they are laughing. They are dying laughing. Not a single one say to me, please, what is the question, man? I mean, come on, we got to pray on the Prophet. But who dare? If he say that, they will kill him. They say, the guy is saying to you, pray on the Prophet, you stop him? Huh? Did you do that? You cannot do that. This is Muhammad, this is God. And this is the potato. He will not answer anything. Suddenly he knows nothing. He wants to study everything. This is what happened when you call a Christian prince. And now you have a tattoo in your bum. Mr. What's your name? I need to post this name in Patreon so people they can put his name in the top of the video. S-A-N-U-R, okay, hold on, let me type it for you. So those who want to quote the video later, you need a name, right? This guy, he is like, I think he decided to tell me his real name because supposedly he thought he would be proud about this conversation. He do not know what is going to come after. S-A-N-U-A-R-A-R-U-L. And his last name is Islam. I don't know what does that mean. Is that a real name? S-A-N-U-A-R-U-L. Islam. I don't know what his real name is, I'm sure. Anyway. And the funny, he have a picture of him. it says behind him science, the Department of Political Science. Anyway, guys, did we have a good time? This video became so long, and I wasn't expecting to go for that long on air. But I miss you all. I was in a trip I have to do, not vacation. Some people, they go, you know, people like us don't have vacation. Vacation maybe for the wealthy, rich, you know. For us, if we get a vacation, it's going to be something totally different. So I'm really happy to have you all. I pray to the Lord that's all of us, we will learn, educate ourselves, and the Muslim will see the truth, and the truth will set them free. Sometime I might go tough, but as you see, our topic is tough. And we are dealing with the devil, not with the flesh. Those people are poor. We know. I'm not angry from this person. I feel sorry for him. He thinks there's a God, his name is Allah. If you kiss a stone, you go to heaven. If you kill some Christian and Jews, and then he called me brother. Either he is a liar, he knew he's lying, deceiving, playing taqiyya, or he did not know. And mostly he knew, sadly. That's why I feel sorry for them. They knew that they are lying. Now let me remind you, this is my book. The link is in the info down there. This is a new translation, or the translation for my book, Deception of Allah in the Basha language. So if you're Indonesian, please download the book and share the link with your friends. Let everybody download and read. It's full of information you never heard before. Very important to have in every house. You can print it in your house, but please, it's not for sale. It's meant to be for free. For free, for my beloved Indonesian Muslims and Christians. We love the Muslims, that's why we want to support them. And I wish I can do more. I wish I can speak to every single Indonesian Muslims to see the truth that he's following a false God and hell is waiting. And the gate of hell is wide and many they will go there. There is nobody can save you, my friend, except the Messiah, the Lord, the Savior. His name is a glory. His act is holy. He said to the Jews, who of you can prove me a sinner? While the Quran confirmed that Muhammad was the biggest fraud ever, to the point even his followers accused him of stealing underwear. I mean, imagine if the disciple of Jesus accused Jesus of stealing such a thing. What kind of a quality of those are the best people of Islam, the disciple of Muhammad, if we can call them disciple, companion, accusing their leader of stealing underwear. And until now, it's not to be found. And the funny Allah, he made a verse about it, but he did not tell us where it is, because obviously it is over the bum of Muhammad. I mean, people accuse Muhammad to be stealing underwear. Shouldn't you tell us where we can find it so you can clear Muhammad's name? No, he said, it's not Muhammad who did it. Which is obviously proof that Muhammad, he did it. Anyway, guys, may the Lord bless you all. Don't forget to download the video. It takes some time, 20 minutes or even longer, if the video is long, to be ready. And after that, you can download the video. With this, I leave you with the peace of Christ. He gave you peace. He is the peace. And he said, I will be with you forever. Every two of you mention my name, I will be between them. I will be the third. He is here with us. He is listening to us. He feels sorry for those Muslims. And the sorrow of God is the hell of man. Which means, when God, he feels sorry for you, that means you are going to hell. You better be careful. For hell is big and waiting, and there's no mercy. The Messiah who came first time with mercy, second time, there's no mercy. For you've been served, you've been told, even he gave his life for you. So what is missing? The missing that you choose adulteress like Muhammad, a fornicator, a cheater, a liar, a thief, a criminal, a child molester. Name one crime in this world can be considered as ugly, disgusting, and Muhammad did not do. Thank you all for being here. May the Lord bless you all. And this is a Christian prince who has been forced by Allah, according to Islam, to insult Allah and expose him and spank him. So all thanks to Allah. For what he did. Take care. Bye-bye.